Greetings and salutations, ladies and gentlemen. Jeffrey Wilson coming to you live and direct from the River Center right here in downtown Davenport, Iowa for Caged Aggression Return of the Champions. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be the biggest event in the promotion's history. Over the next couple nights, you're going to be seeing veterans from the UFC, LFA, Bellator. This is going to be jam-packed, ladies and gentlemen. And joining our broadcast team tonight, he needs no introduction, but he gets one anyway. He is an absolute legend of the sport. First UFC lightweight champion, he is Lil Evil, Jens Pulver. Jens, how are we doing this evening? And give us your thoughts on night one's jam-packed stat card, which obviously includes our main event, Frank Shulman and Eric Wisely, who you're very familiar with.
You know, the thing is, just being able to see fights again, it's been a long time coming. We've had, you know, a lot of COVID, a lot of issues, obviously. And the fact that we can finally get back in here and bring the entertainment to the crowd, to the fans, to the people who want to watch this, everybody at home, being able to watch this fight again, you know, there's something to be said about that. Props to Caged Aggression, props to Iowa to letting this happen. And speaking of Iowa, they've got a fighter a lot, you know, that he's been out there, he's fought in the UFC, Strikeforce, Bellator. He has multiple titles in smaller events. Eric Wisely he's an amazing fighter, and it's so cool because I'm hearing that this might be his last fight. And so it's an honor to be able to call his fight, because again, he's represented Iowa to the best of his abilities, and you know what I mean? I'm proud of him. So
it's absolutely gonna be fun. It's going to be a very momentous night. Excitement personified that you will not soon forget, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so very thankful to be calling the fights with Lil Evil tonight. Without further ado, let's throw it up to our ring announcer, Jason Vargas, to kick off our first bout of the evening.
This is the moment you've been waiting for, as 7G Distributing Bud Light proudly presents Caged Aggression 27, Return of the Champions, our annual two-night event hosted by the River Center. My name is Jason, your official voice from inside the Kama Cage, and I'd like to welcome you all to a Caged Aggression event like no other to date. An event with a name that's more than catchy words. It's an event that, after months away from the public's eye, past, present, and future Caged Aggression champions make their return with a chance to showcase their skills to those in attendance tonight and countless others around the world. Special thanks to all of you dedicated fans for your support and patience leading up to this weekend. Give yourselves a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. A quick reminder for those in attendance this evening, the 3rd Street entrance is closed and is being used as a smoke area. The 2nd Street entrance will be the only entrance for the evening. You'll need a wristband for re-entry from the smoking area. A mask will be required when not in your seat, and please respect social distancing while in lines. Once again, Caged Aggression and the River Center, thank you for your support. An overflowing amount of appreciation is due to our event partners, the River Center, official home of Caged Aggression MMA, 7G Distributing Bud Light, thank them often and responsibly, La Quinta Inns and Suites, Ducky's Formal Wear, Galesburg, Ruby's, Affordable Auto Care, Lynch Heating and Plumbing, Yabba Dabba's House of Glass, Banker's Life Agent Kaylee Stout, the Iowa Army National Guard, Wisely Tree Care, Reyes Law Group, Rittmer Incorporated Excavating, J&L Lawn Care and Landscaping, and the Pearled Up Podcast presents. Let's hear it for all of our event partners, ladies and gentlemen. Special thanks to our production team, Mindprint Productions, Music Connection, and Say Uncle Photography. Much gratitude to all fighters, coaches, and teams for their tireless commitment to be here tonight, and to Caged Aggression President CEO Mike Goodwin for your endless drive. Let's hear another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. All of tonight's bouts have been sanctioned by the Iowa Athletic Commission, Executive Director Joe Walsh, Deputy Ben Wilson, and Inspector Zach Mickelright. Our other cage side officials for the evening, Greaseman Kevin Knight Anderson, Timekeeper Larry Stone, Judges Josh Stewart, Alex Orozco, and Matt White. Our cage side physician for this evening is Dr. Metcalf. Our cage girls for the night, the lovely Jessica and Serena. Color commentary provided by Jeffrey Wilson and former UFC lightweight champion, Jens Little Evil Pulver. And when the action begins, our referees in charge, the boss, Bruce Allen and Josh Stewart. Now, if you'll please rise and help me welcome the Iowa Army National Guard and Miss Iowa 2020, Emily Tinsman, for the playing of our national anthem.
Walkout music, I'm giving him an absolute A plus. This is catchy. I like it.
This is Little Evil approved. Yeah. Music. Fighting out of Absolute Martial Arts and from Belgrade, Serbia, Miljan Djukanovic.
Stop. I can't hear them.
You know, his beginning of MMA is a little unconventional. He started fighting through his wife, was a professional MMA fighter before him.
But he started what? He started fighting his wife?
His wife started fighting before him.
And so he's like, I can do this too. She right. says, all right, let's find out. Let's find out.
He's probably tired of getting choked out by her.
Right? It's like, that's it. I'm going to, let me do this too. Might as well.
Yes.
Where is he from?
He's fighting out of Absolute Martial Arts in Des Moines, Iowa, but he's originally from Belgrade, Serbia.
Oh, wow. Okay.
This is the
A couple of his heroes being Khabib Nurmagomedov and Daniel Cormier, some of the folks who transitioned from wrestling to MMA.
So we're doing the polls online, as you can see right here.
Absolutely, ladies and gentlemen. Joining us tonight is Leah Mathis. She's going to be facilitating the live chat, Q&A, and the polls that we're doing tonight. So when you go to cagedaggression.tv, you will see a space there to ask questions, to enjoy the chat, to interact with us as we talk tonight. If you've got a question for Lil Eel over here, fire away. You got questions for the beautiful Leah, fire away. If you got questions for the Caramel Sexy Sensation, Jeffrey Wilson, fire away.
Ha! Did you say Caramel Sexy?
Yes, baby.
My man. Yeah. Hey, I got to see one thing I was going to ask about this. He's just excited to be able to finally compete. And that's the one thing I think for all these guys.
Yeah.
Just being able to finally compete. I'm so glad that we get to sit here. We get to be live. We get to watch fights, break them down.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
It's good to have a little slice of normal back.
So far on the polls, guys, the first question is, who will win tonight in this first bout between Gene and Miljan? Is that how you say it? Is that correct?
I would say Miljan.
Miljan? Milan. Milan.
Milan.
Milan. Okay. So far on the polls, guys, we have 75% of the people think that Milan is going to win, and 23% think that Gene is going
to
win.
Gene Zarbano making his way to the cage out of Henry Martial Arts.
I like it. He said, I had some friends that were doing it, so I'm going to just go ahead and I figured, why not? Once I turned 18, I'm going to go ahead and fight too. That sounds like me. I was in college and everybody was fighting. They said, hey, why don't you do one of these? Like, okay. I mean, might as well.
Well, he definitely.
Our first bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Cage Aggression Amateur Lightweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'8" tall and weighed in at 155 pounds. He trains at Absolute Martial Arts and Fitness. Joining us from Des Moines, Iowa, Milan Djukanovic. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 151 pounds. He trains at Henry's MMA and Skywalker Boxing and is sponsored by Renegade Kombucha, Village Vape Cafe, and Elite Loyalty Combat Sports and Marketing Management. Joining us from Anita, Iowa, Gene Zarbano.
Gene Zarbano, knowing what he's up against, saying my guy was a very strong wrestler, so he's looking forward to being tested. Gene feels his striking is going to be the deciding factor here tonight. Meanwhile, Milan feels he's able to adapt and throw unorthodox scrambles.
Ooh, I like that lead leg that he's already thrown off the bat. He's changed up, hit once to the leg and then once to the head. He's changing levels with it.
Always good to be predictably unpredictable, right?
Well, and that's the thing, and these setups, using your feet as setups is the best way to get things started, yeah? When you reach out there reaching, leg kicks work.
Oh, nice leg kick once again. He's got a little bit of a reach on him, Milan does. Hopefully he can use that to his advantage. Got him right here in front of us up against the cage. Looks like Gene trying to go for a bit of a takedown, maybe. Milan fighting it off.
Hip position right now, and you can tell Milan trying to get this throw in front. He's got the hips down low. He's able to roll, and then he got rolled through by Gene.
Ooh, caught that leg kick, champ.
Really good scramble right here. I think right about now, perfect lead hook, rear leg. It's a great combination. Always
Absolutely.
Coming out the beginning, throwing with that lead hook to set things up.
Using that reach with that leg kick, too. Seems to be finding a home with that.
Now it looks like the nerves have kind of gotten out of the way, and now they're getting down, taking over in the center, and they're just, now they've slowed down, and now we see the game plans take over. Yeah. There you go, Superman to close the distance, come back and throws a hook, does Milan.
You talked about, you know, getting rid of those butterflies. How important is that on a platform like this, in a big show like this?
You know, and the thing is, it's more than anything, it's just getting that connection with your corners, allowing yourself to calm down. You got to get out of that tunnel vision. You got to be able to get in there where you can see. Everything happens so fast. At first, you got to slow it down and get back into reality, you know what I mean? To be able to see everything that's happening, and then if you can hear your corner, then it's perfect.
Ooh.
Champ, you can see that leg, that left leg on Zarbano already starting to welt up.
Yeah, he's doing a great job right now. Gene has a good game plan, kicking that inside leg, kicking the inside of the lead leg, and setting up the takedown, and the way he's rushing in, good job. Milan's got him pushed up against the fence right now, head in the pocket, controlling the position.
That's a nice scrambling.
Oh, yeah. There we go.
Good takedown. Good heading on. Good takedown in the guard.
Let's see what kind of ground game Milan has.
There you go. He gets the hands off the mat. First thing they yell. And you can tell right now, Gene's starting to move out a little bit. Open the guard up. You can tell he's looking for an arm. Tried to hook him. Milan pops up. Good knowledge.
Ooh, going for that, going for the possible heel hook.
Oh, we had a heel hook tying.
Absolutely. Good round there for both competitors.
They seem pretty evenly matched. It was pretty good. I like that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they did a really good job. It was just a good scramble back and forth, setting it up. I think using the leg kicks right off the bat for Gene is giving, is opening things up. But both of them are sticking with their game plan. I do like when he threw that lead hook, rear leg. It's a great combination. Starting off, instead of a jab, throw the lead hook. That was really good. So now it's, again, you can tell they're kind of starting to get calm, and they're able to hear in the crowd again. I like it that it just, we can't have so many people in the crowd. It's more like being in Japan, where it's nice and quiet, and you can hear everything. I'm a fan of that. I'm a fan of being able to hear the corners.
Don't you think that helps them focus a little bit more?
I think it absolutely does. Yeah. More like in a gym, where they're most comfortable, is when they do things in the gym, right? Because it's the same people, and they know their coaches, and they're just comfortable. But when you get out here and you start getting live, everything, you get that tunnel vision. Got to get out of that fast.
Yeah, it definitely reminds me of Pride. Yeah, look at his legs are definitely welted up. Zarbano's.
Oh, yeah. He got
definitely
good
gonna, he's going to have that mobility slowed down as Milan keeps chopping away at those legs. There we go. Take it to him. He's starting to check those kicks now, finally.
Yeah, and he's doing a good job of throwing that right hand lead hook.
Milian doing a great job putting his tools together with that teak kick there, setting up for the other leg kicks.
Well, then, if you watch Gene, except when he closed in on that distance, like he was using his distance a little more, throwing the leg kicks, which I like, make Milan have to come into here. He tried to go for a salto. It backfired. He fell into the mount. Gene's got him in the mount position now. Ooh, over under, but he bullied through and powered him over. Nice move by Milan. There you go. I nice love left to the liver. Can I see that all day? Gene throws a nice left to the liver and comes back with the right hand. All day.
Ooh, nice tempered overhand right there.
Go into that. Forward. Forward.
See, Milan's starting to breathe a little bit, but you see how he's giving him his space? Gene wants that space, utilizing that range, utilizing that reach a little more. And again, see that lead hook, rear leg? That's gonna be damaging. Milan coming forward keeps the action moving. That's his fight. Get inside that phone booth and throw down. There you go. See, throwing those big, nasty hooks just like he threw four of them right there.
Leg kicks, finding his home. Yeah, pardon me, folks, that first round, I was mixing up my fighters there.
It's like trying to do another takedown.
Pushing up against that cage. Another issue, as always, is stamina, endurance. You know, you take so much energy out pushing each other up against the cage and holding off with those underhooks.
Well, you start getting into the anaerobic side of it. That's the wrestling fitness, that push, that pull. There's everybody, you know, the running, conditioning side of it, but it's that lactic acid building up in those muscles. And all of a sudden, when those start getting numb, that doesn't come back. That's that energy bar in the video game that goes down and down, and it just doesn't come back. Cardio, you can take a breath, come back, and, you know what I mean, and you can rest. But when that anaerobic, all that wrestling, that's the muscles turning purple. That's that lactic acid getting in there and makes it tough.
How scary is that when you're just gassed out and you're looking across at an opponent that opponent that's just full of energy still?
It's beyond intimidating. Again, old military fighting system, that was us.
Yes.
We're the one bouncing up and down never, and it's and try to intimidate them. If everything is, are you going to those championship rounds, you know that you have a lot of gas in the tank. That's scary.
Yes, yes. You guys were definitely known for that.
Yeah, I show the whole crew.
There you go. The lovely Leah.
Nice job. Good job.
Let's
good
get
round.
Round.
Good round. Very close round. Both of these rounds.
They're
very
so
close.
Evenly matched. I don't see one dominating the other yet.
I'm glad I don't have to judge this because.
Yeah, that'd be a tough one.
Yeah, I like the welt on the underlined leg right there.
We got a little injury over the eye.
Looks like it. Like Gene got himself a little gash over there on the right eye.
Battle wounds.
Well, that's the thing, though, because he's doing a great job when Lund gets inside and he's throwing those body shots, the hooks. That's what you do. When too many times people try to get inside, and when they get there, they don't do anything. They end up being in a clinch, right? And that's when I think when you get inside is when you got to do your damage.
Stay
start
busy.
Throwing those hooks. Yeah,
without
you got
to
make it happen.
Go there, yeah. CaseAggression.tv, ladies and gentlemen, jump on board. You can be a part of the show tonight. Q&A, we're having some chats. Some polls, all
yeah.
Very interactive with our fans tonight. Our lovely Leah over here, Leah Mathis, is going to be kind of our moderator.
That's right. Get on there. Jump online and ask me some questions.
Yes.
Ask the fellas some questions.
Absolutely.
Happy to answer them for you guys.
How did I get to be so pretty? We can talk about it.
It made me blush.
I joke, ladies and
gentlemen. Yeah, I'm not that good looking.
Coming out blazing. Ooh. Little double from Milan. Didn't quite hold on to it there.
Well, I think he did a good job of backing out because you could tell Gene was going to go for that the guillotine. And you can only get so deep in and then you got to back out. So he did a good job. And now him trying to close the distance. Again, if Gene takes advantage, again, lead hook rear leg has been his money shot if he can do it right there. See, dragging that rear leg.
Yes.
He needs to start throwing that more.
Well, Gene seems to be finding some success with those leg kicks. I don't know if Milian's legs are working like they would two rounds ago.
He can take those kicks, though, can he?
He certainly can. Uh-oh, it's like a low blow. Oh,
yo,
referee didn't stop
oh,
it.
He thought it was
turned
a low
his back
blow.
On his opponent.
When you're not the ref, remember, you don't decide the low blow. You don't decide the low blow. The ref does. You don't just walk away. Got to get a gangster punch in the head for doing it. Now he's got locking up a guillotine.
Oh.
Defend yourself at all times, ladies and gentlemen.
Right now, I think Gene needs to just pay attention to the fact that Milan is starting to gas. He's getting
yes.
tired. These shots are not as they're not as explosive as they once were. He's able to sprawl on him. Throw these body shots. Steal this round by beating him up, sprawl and brawl, and take this round. He looks to be the fresher fighter, so
without
now right
doubt.
There, keep that leg back, throw the body shots. Punish him, go for an
armbar. Nice. Oh,
that was a good armbar.
Position before submission, but he went for the armbar, and now he's on his back.
Well, how much does the sweat contribute to that, too?
A
slipping
lot,
off? Yeah.
Without a doubt. You add in the anaerobic, you add in the fatigue, and then you go after an armbar like that, and then all of a sudden, you know.
Good job. Short time, Milan. Good job. There you go.
Everybody won.
Posture.
They can see the. I need the link. That'd be the thing.
CagedAggression.tv, ladies and gentlemen.
CagedAggression.tv.
Otherwise, no soup for you.
Hold on, listen. Get your head up. Get your head up and punch. Get your head up and punch.
Milan's corner over here screaming instructions, telling him to post up and start dropping some bombs.
Definitely slippery over there. Starting to get sweaty.
Yeah, it's one of those kind of inquantifiable components of fighting. You go for a couple rounds of that sweat.
Mm-hmm.
You just can't necessarily do some of the.
You can't get freaking on the ground.
Well, can't especially the submissions. You just can't lock it in like you normally could if you were dry.
Let's go.
Well, and that's one thing too. Milan's got to realize. I don't know if he's feeling it that he's winning this round, but he can't coast in this position.
Yeah.
The open guard, posture up. Time to pass the guard. Get out. Make a move.
Even though Gene's in the guard, he's staying busy.
Yeah, exactly. You can tell he wants to set up maybe a triangle choke or not, but end of the round. Good job.
That's three rounds, ladies and gentlemen. CageAggression.tv. Tell us who you think won that one. Was it Miljan Djukanovic or Gene Zarbano?
That was a good fight.
That was a really good fight. Very close.
I like how they're shaking hands and hugging right after the fight.
Always
too.
Good sportsmanship. Very you always good want sportsmanship. To see that.
Love it.
We await the judges' decision, ladies and gentlemen. Our first bout of the evening has come to a conclusion. We await the word on the victor. Again, this is night one of a two-night jam-packed fight card, the biggest in Cage Aggression history. Both fighters staying busy.
You guys just tell them to go to CageAggression.tv if they want to ask any questions.
I just didn't. But yeah, be a part of the show, ladies and gentlemen. Be a part of the Q&A, be a part of the chat, be a part of the polls. CageAggression.tv. Very good fight, man. Very good way to kick off the card.
A lot of action. Nobody got too tired or anything like that. It was a lot of action, which was good.
Yeah.
They look like they can go one more round.
I was going
to
say, it'd be interesting to see maybe one more.
I don't
want to
judge this. Yeah, one more round.
Jam-packed card, ladies and gentlemen. We have amateurs, we have professionals tonight. We have veterans from the UFC, the LFA, Bellator over these next couple days. Buckle up. Shout out to Cage Aggression, Mike Goodwin, for his perseverance in these many, many months of making sure that this event happened.
I mean, that's the coolest thing. I'm sitting here watching fights again. I'm cage-side watching fights. Normally, I'm on my stream watching old school fights, breaking down all the different fights and stuff like that, but I'm live doing a fight. It's crazy.
Live, ladies and gentlemen, with the legend of the sport, UFC lightweight champion Jens Pulver, and then tomorrow night, the Croatian sensation, the captain of the Miličić Fighting System Hall of Famer, Pat Miličić, will be joining me in the broadcast booth calling the action. You don't get much better than that. Two legendary fighters calling a legendary fight card.
What do you guys think? Do you have any predictions? The outcome of this fight?
I think Gene pulled that one out.
You think so?
I think the most significant strikes, he was busier.
He connected more.
I don't know the head coach. Snoop,
yeah, his legs look a little worse for wear.
He took him though, didn't
Miljan?
He?
He did. He
didn't
did.
Phase
Ladies
him
and gentlemen,
much.
We go to your judges' scorecard for our decision. Our judges scored this contest 30-27, 30-27, and 29-28. Declaring your winner by unanimous decision, Gene Zarbano.
I'd love to say I'm shocked, but
I'm not gonna say
he
shocked.
He called that one,
but I don't know about all three rounds. We thought it was we thought the fight was a little closer than that. But that's all right.
He landed those kicks though, every time.
He did land kicks, and he was kind of dominating on that aspect.
Yeah,
and the sprawling brawl. And ring generalship, I guess, and everything's so even.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? In the scrambling and the fighting aspect of it, the ring generalship, selling it, you know?
All right, that's we're one here thing with I'm your winner, Gene Zarbano. Gene, first time here in the Caged Aggression cage. Very tough opponent in Milan, man. What's on your mind right now after picking up a big win?
I'm impressed with myself. I knew that he was going to come out and wrestle me, which is not my strong suit. I'm a striker. And
like this one.
I'm just happy for the kid to win, and yeah.
Couple great moments there. You showed some great takedown defense. There was a little bit of confusion there in the closing round of the fight, man. What went on, man? What happened there? Can you explain it to the crowd?
I stepped in and threw a knee. He was saying that I hit him in the, testicles, and
Me?
I thought I hit him. You know, he said it. I kind of like panicked. I didn't know what to do, and then the ref didn't call it, so, I just kept striking.
I was going to say, you showed great awareness there as far as
no
in the cage
button.
Goes. I want to congratulate you one more time on the win, but before I let you go, anything that you want to add or anyone that you want to conclude before I let you get to the locker room?
Yeah, I want to thank Eric, Josh, Coach Danny at Skywalker. He's been giving me good tips since I've been going there. And I want to thank my sponsors and the family that's watching back home. I wish they could have been here, and I'm glad to get the win. And thank you guys for putting me on your show.
Well, once again, congratulations on the performance tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Gene Zarbano.
Hey, guys.
Garrett Kelson coming up with Marty Vansell as his opponent this evening, ladies and gentlemen.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get back up. I ain't sharp as knife in the
door. We bring in this second bout of the evening.
Once again, go to cageprogression.tv. Go ahead and join in on our poll. Tell us who you think is going to win this bout.
Young Garrett Kelson going up against Martin Vansa. We got Garrett Kelson making his way to the ring, to the cage rather, Bloomington Team 1 BJJ out of Danvers, Illinois.
Once again, he wins on entrance music.
He decided to get into MMA after he was looking for a way to compete after wrestling in college. Obviously, wrestling and scrambling is going to be one of his strong suits. Dan H-Bomb Henderson is one of his heroes in the MMA world.
I like this song, guys.
Yeah, it's definitely dope, right?
I like it.
Coming a little
That's
bit of
the way it is in life and love.
He's from where do we see he's from?
Danvers, Illinois.
There you go.
Bloomington Team Country 1 boy. BJJ.
Oh, day. Oh, all right. It's a one-upper on the entrance because, wow, never mind. Again.
Martin Vansell fighting out of Central Illinois Combat Club. Another entrance song, Lil Evil approved.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, cageaggression.tv. We have another poll. Who will win this one?
Ending soon, so go ahead and put in your vote.
Absolutely. Martin Vansell facing off against Garrett Kelson right here in the middle at the River Center live in Davenport, Iowa. For Cage Aggression, return of the champions underway.
We had Garrett up by 60% compared to Marty at 40% in the polls. Who's going to win this one? But now Marty is slowly climbing up, and it's 53-46%.
Neck and neck, ladies and gentlemen.
Neck and neck. Oh, Marty just took the lead, 53%. Think he's going to win this bout.
Our next bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Heavyweight Division, powered by Affordable Auto Care. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'11" tall and weighed in at 227 pounds. He trains with Bloomington Team 1 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and is sponsored by Nussbaum Enterprises Incorporated, Mason Contractor, Greethy Rose Construction and Restoration, Illinois Outlaws Outdoors, B13 Cycles, The Vault, Bar and Grill, and Limelight Graphics. Joining us from Danvers, Illinois, Garrett Kelson! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6'1" tall and weighed in at 251 pounds. He trains with the Central Illinois Combat Club. Joining us from Spring Bay, Illinois, Marty Vansell!
All right, here we go.
All right, to get on the good foot and do the bad thing, ladies and gentlemen, Garrett Kelson and Marty Vansell.
Ooh, he went in.
Start out with a straight left. Right. Wow. The heavyweights. Don't blink, ladies and gentlemen. This one could be over before you know it.
Garrett's deep in on the body lock.
It's hard to move that weight around.
It is. You got to keep those hips low. It looks like he's got him up a little bit, trying to twist him. Good scrambling, though. Ooh.
Right up right there.
That's what Garrett was saying. Some of his abilities are wrestling and scrambling. They're starting to trade right there.
Yeah, exchanging is not one of his abilities at this moment. He's got to get in and start throwing a little bit because Martin is throwing combination after combination. Literally just ripped off about 16 straight punches.
Ooh, sure did.
Look, he's just keeping
double
hand,
right there.
Double jab right hand, stunned him.
Oh, he cracked him. He's down, ladies and gentlemen. Referee calls a stop to the match.
Oh.
Garrett Nelson. That was a rough one.
Oh, my gosh.
Marty Vansell with a rather quick KO of Garrett Nelson, making rather short work. He was piecing them up, though.
Yeah, Marty just decided to step in. They were good straight shots, good combinations. And then he was able to start changing upstairs, downstairs, hit his body. Then he came in with the uppercut. And it was just too much. You could tell Garrett, again, wrestling and scrambling were his abilities, but no real take on that stand-up. And you could tell he just kind of stuck out there just reaching, hoping he could grab a hold of something. All the while you're getting pieced up with these punches and there's nothing you can do.
Yeah. Face shot after face shot after face shot.
Yeah, that was a couple two-piece and a biscuit.
That was hard to watch.
But again, that's such a good observation, Champ. Some people are, you know, so desperate. If you're just so single-dimensional as a wrestler, you don't know how to protect yourself, especially with, you know, the lack of striking background.
Well, and that's it. You end up reaching out like a flinch, you know, where you're flinching is like this, and you just kind of stick your hands out, and you're just hoping to grab something where you literally are just blind. You're not seeing anything. And when somebody's starting to hit you in the ear holes, come back with the uppercuts, hitting you in the chin, hitting your head, changing the levels, and then it's just too much.
It's
like a barrage. Where you start looking around, see where the other three people literally that are hitting you. I'm serious. It just feels like you're getting mugged, without a doubt.
It looked like he was getting jumped. But kudos to him for stepping in the cage.
Always.
Your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 52 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by TKO, Marty Vansell.
Marty Vansell, once again, making short work of Garrett Kelson. Kudos to Garrett for stepping in the cage, though. 52 seconds of the first round, Marty picking up the W.
Nothing but action-packed right there.
That was.
There was not a second to spare.
Short but sweet.
All right, we're here with our winner, Marty Vansell. Marty, man, I know you have a lot on your mind since your first appearance for Caged Aggression, man. Come out here wanting to turn things around. You had this thing in high gear from the start, man. How's it feel picking up that win in a very, very impressive fashion?
Oh, it feels wonderful. I love it.
Now, as far as picking up the big win here tonight, you know, didn't take a whole lot of damage as far as things go. Do you have any quick turnaround plans or anything like that you can let the fans know?
I honestly have no idea. Whatever coach wants me to do is what I'm going to do.
There you go. Well, look, I did want to ask you this. You came out here, kept things standing up. Was that the game plan the whole time, was to really throw leather tonight and get the big knockout? Or?
Yeah, I was going to keep standing up, and then if it went to the ground, it went to the ground, but stand up for sure.
Well, I know you got a lot of reason to celebrate right now, so I'm going to let you get to that. But before I do, anything you want to add before I let you get to the locker room?
No, I'm all right. Thank you.
Sure thing. He's a man of few words. Put a whole lot of punches into this game. Let's hear it one more time for your winner, Marty Vansell.
Absolutely.
Well done.
Punches and bunches.
When you have service or maintenance issues, call the maintenance team you can trust at Lynch Heating and Plumbing. We take care of all your heating and plumbing needs. We are a reliable, family-run business providing quality service to homeowners and businesses in the Quad Cities. Trust in Lynch to get the job done. In a pinch, call Lynch at 563-209-0039 or check out our new website to book online at lynchheatingandplumbing.com.
my good friend Tommy Lynch. We got Drake Stern coming up, ladies and gentlemen, against Liam Morris.
Don't forget to go to cageaggression.tv. Go ahead and join that poll and vote for who you think is going to win this bout.
Absolutely.
We're at 66% think Drake is going to win. 33% think that Liam is going to win. Go ahead and get your vote in there. Every vote matters.
Well, you got Drake, another person with a wrestling background who always wanted to try MMA, so here he is giving it a try.
Love it. Yeah.
Wrestling since the age of 4. Even a couple years over here at Augustana College.
Neck and neck on the polling. 50-50. Viewers think it's 50-50 shot right now.
Well, and another seize the day kind of opportunity. He always wanted to do this, and his girlfriend really pushed him, letting him know that he would probably regret it if he didn't pursue this. So here he is, following his dream. Good for him.
Absolutely.
Fighting out of Marty's Martial Arts.
All right, we've got Drake taking the lead in the polls right now. 61% think that he is going to pull this W.
Still rolling fairly neck and neck there, but yes, Drake taking a bit of a lead there.
Taking a little bit of a lead, 66% now.
Oh!
All right, we got Drake at 70% now. He has taken quite a lead.
Liam Morris making his way to the cage. Fighting out of the Soft Valley Jiu-Jitsu Gym, Sterling, Illinois. A very common beginning of MMA. He started because he was bullied.
My man.
I like it.
My man.
Comeback kid.
One of his favorites is down in my neck of the woods, Michael Chandler. St. Louis kid. He has done parkour, breakdancing, and some hand-to-hand combat.
Did you say parkour?
He did say, I did say parkour.
Savvy.
Feeling his striking is his strength.
I believe I have a hard time seeing the mask, but I see people moving out of the way, but I know I believe that Dave Lemley is his coach, one of my longtime training partners, one of the OGs of MFS. Too many rounds, too many punches in the face from each other, so I'm excited to see his kid fight for sure. But that's, I got to give a shout out to Dave Lemley. I got to talk to him a little bit earlier, much so. I haven't seen him in a minute, but it's really cool to, you know, see the guys that you moved around with for so long. And yeah, he's one of the originals.
Well, success leaves clues, and hopefully he spreads some of that knowledge from the MFS. So maybe one day he could be an owner of the gold.
Right, that's one of those
ladies
things,
and gentlemen,
passing on the knowledge.
Our next battle of the evening is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Flyweight Division, powered by Rubies. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 124 pounds. He trains at Marty's Martial Arts and is sponsored by Main Street Barber Company, Luxury Nails by Lexi, Walking's Windmill Team, and Shittles Buffing. Joining us from Aledo, Illinois, Drake Stern. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 124 pounds. He trains at Salt Valley Jiu-Jitsu and is sponsored by Big Dick's Custom Rods. Joining us from Sterling, Illinois, Liam Morris!
Liam Morris, ladies and gentlemen, rocking the Muay Thai shorts. We'll see if we see some Muay Thai come from this young man.
He's got some sliders underneath him. Remember those from my softball days. Is that not what those are?
Oh my goodness, the sliding pads. That'd be so cheap if you could do that to avoid leg kicks. Oh!
All right, going to the polls real quick. We've got 60% in favor of Drake in this bout.
Drizzy leading the polls. Ooh. Nice inside leg kick right there. both firing away with those leg kicks.
He's very acrobatic, isn't he?
Parkour.
Light on his feet.
Well, I like that. He's up on his wheels. He's moving around on the balls of his feet, keeping the energy going, right? Little feints forward. He starts getting that movement. It opens things up.
He's dancing.
Looks like Drake might have a little bit of a reach on him, too.
Good parry and rear leg right there.
Nice block for that high right leg kick. Left leg kick, rather. Ooh, nice recovery to launch a vicious leg kick.
Face.
That connected.
Okay.
These boys are going off.
Good job, wrestling. Good knee by Liam. Got the guillotine. Okay. Got to be careful. Now
yeah, definitely
got to
be careful. Little Matt Hughes, Carlos Newton business right there.
Good slam on the way down. Now he's got to be careful. Keep his hands off the mat. Go ahead and get inside. See, Drake's just trying to sit there. He's got to wait when the guard opens up. He's got to get that right arm free a little bit. Liam's doing a good job of just throwing, just trying to keep the guard closed, keep him wrapped up, and get this ref to stand the fight up.
I see a lot of those kind of heel strikes like that when you're in, when somebody's in your guard. What do those do right there? Those kill
them. Heels in your kidneys.
Yes.
Get down. Are you kidding me?
Right.
Move you. You can't be comfortable, right? Sitting there putting little heels in the kidneys. Reminds me of BJ was throwing heels in the thigh, the back of the thigh, real good at doing that. Mm. Keeping everything irritated.
Utilizing every single weapon.
He's really doing a good job of locking up Garrett right now and keeping him on the bottom.
Yeah.
Liam's doing a good job. He's wanting to get that hip out to the side. He's doing, putting his feet on the hips, open guard.
Trying to get a
little
distance.
Doing a great job of staying active. And right here, I mean, he's going to watch. I know he wants to go out to this elbow on the left side.
We're trying to isolate an arm for a triangle.
Oh.
Back to their feet. Both fighters in the center of the cage.
See, now if you notice, Drake's doing a lot. He's watching Liam. See where those feints can start to play up. I'd like to see Liam get back up on his feet and start bouncing, add in those feints, jab, feint, and get the kid flinching to set up these punches and kicks.
Nice.
Action, reaction. Let's go. Kick his leg. Let's go, Drake. Come on.
Both going for those leg kicks.
Ooh, a good high kick to the head. That's the one thing Liam don't like doing, is blocking to the kick to the head. He gotta get them hands up a little higher. He blocks everything else. He doesn't like those head kicks.
They both seem in good spirits, though.
Absolutely.
Both doing great.
Firing away.
Smiling Drake, at the end of that round.
Drake seems to have a few inches on him, too, which I think is going to make a difference with some of those leg kicks finding a home.
He seems like he's got some dance in his history. I mean, he's very, very light on his feet, isn't he?
He's definitely on his feet. Yeah. You know, that's that good striking.
Makes it look easy.
Moving around. Yeah, he definitely does. Definitely wants to stay mobile.
A lot of spin moves.
Definitely don't want to be an easy target.
No.
Staying on the move.
The beautiful ring girls.
For sure.
Taking their laps here.
Hey.
I don't have a pause button. I'm not in my stream right now. I can't pause.
Excuse me,
what round
gentlemen.
Is this? Pause. I'm just playing.
Ready to call the resumption of action right here, starting round two. Drake Stern, Liam Morris right here at the River Center right here in downtown Davenport for Caged Aggression, Return of the Champions, calling the action with UFC Monster lightweight champion, former lightweight champion, Jens Pulver.
Oi, good parry, leg kick.
And of course, the lovely Liam Mathis.
Ooh,
starting out on fire. Whoa! Okay.
He just hopped off the
caught him
with,
in the air.
All right, he's parkour. Parkour. He should have yelled it right
he's
there.
He's on ice games mode.
Oh, yeah. That's beautiful. He bounced off the cage. See, that's what I'm talking about, though. Limber, moving around. And see, he adds in these feints. He needs to do that more and utilize that and confuse Drake.
Looked like Drake almost caught him in the air with one of those leg kicks, though.
Yes.
He's fun. He's a fun fighter to watch.
Absolutely.
Very entertaining.
What do you think about Liam needing to set his strikes up a little better? It seems like he's throwing a little too far outside. and he's missing a lot of those.
Yeah, I mean, it's the ability to want to step in sometimes. Again, when you get into that range and you kind of can tell that you're in that range, it kind of, it causes you to tense up a little bit, right? And that's one thing is, but you got to get in there. That's why, again, circling, setups, feints, get your way in so you can land those strikes, because you all just punch them a little too far out.
Which takes a lot out of you. You load up and you miss. That's...
It's disheartening. There's a good inside leg, there's a good leg kick and left hand, walking him down.
Oh, he's going for the takedown. Oh!
Scrambling like a champ.
Wow, good job, good job.
You're doing amazing.
Drake going for a single there.
Nice job with the scramble. Still keeping the scramble going. He wants that front headlock.
He's going for an anaconda.
Spin around behind, going to take his back. Watch out, don't get bucked off.
Ooh. Not too high. Drake's a little high. I'm sorry, Liam's a little high, right, champ?
Yeah, his hips are up a little too high. He's got to. Drake needs to know this and start bucking, because if Liam can get those feet in, now he's getting in his spurs. He's going to be able to dig in, sit back, and start throwing punches. Now we're in a bad situation for Drake.
Without a doubt. Liam trying to go for that rear naked. He's in a great position to have the hooks in. Body triangle.
Big body.
And he's in a pickle now.
Little close to the cage, too. Sometimes that makes it hard to really lock in the technique.
Taking some hits to the back of the head.
Looks like,
There we go.
There we go.
Nice.
Drake back to the top.
Oh, with anger. Now he's got to get
now
down.
He's going for his own guillotine. Oh, he might have that locked in, champ. Oh, he let it go.
Battle Daddy's in side control, sitting out towards the head. Good job. Now you got to start throwing some punches to get this back. Nice. End of
that
the down.
That was a nice, strong.
That was amazing.
Good
How
job.
How do you come
Drake.
Back like that at the end and get that, like, completely stole everything? For a minute there, Liam was winning his fight, and then Drake comes back and goes with the finish.
Just when you think
zone.
One of them's got it down, and then the other one, nope, not, just kidding. That was awesome.
What's up with our cagedaggression.tv polls, Miss Leah?
Right now, we've got Drake in the lead. It's starting to catch up. It's starting to even out a little bit. I think people watch the bout. 57% are in favor of Drake. 42% are in favor of Liam.
These young boys are scrapping.
This is my favorite fight so far.
Yeah, these two have been going. I really like the way that Liam's approach, again, the way he moves outside, but if he would just step in just a little more, you can see. But he has softened up Drake's leg. You can see the bruises.
Yeah, he definitely
Look at the welts on his left leg.
Oh, yeah.
You can see it starting to set up. And that's one thing that hopefully the coach is over there telling him, I need that lead hook. I need that. I need you to kick that left leg.
Definitely need to start checking those, too.
What do you do after a big fight?
Again. I sleep for quite a bit. I eat a lot of food.
That's what I was going to guess.
Drink a lot of beer for a few days and sleep for quite a bit.
I don't blame you.
Drake Stern, Liam Moore starting out round three, ladies and gentlemen. Third and final round. These guys have been going at it. Again, another leg kick. If it ain't broke, don't break it. Inside leg kick there.
If he would just, there you go, utilize those hands and step inside. Jab, cross, lead leg. Jab, cross, hook, rear leg. You know, set that up a little bit. Move. Yes. That kick right there. Look, he's limping bad.
Finally taking his toll.
Yeah, you got to know this. You got to set it up.
He's going to the same leg. Same leg every time.
That has got to be the scariest feeling in the world being Drake right now, when you know that leg can't take another kick and Liam knows it's happening.
And your mobility is completely compromised.
Yes, but he gets in on a single leg. Good job on the scramble by Liam. Drake's doing a great job of pushing him up against the fence, so making sure that he's going to get this takedown.
Push him up against the cage. Down to the mat. Nice takedown. Drake's trying to get in there. Looks like, I don't know what he's working for there. Chan, what are you seeing him working in there?
Well, you know, there's a possibility for a guillotine, but again, the hand fighting is great, and he wants to hit him with that power half and take him over. Now he's got a full mount. He's got basically a Saturday night ride in wrestling. He's literally going to pin him right now. if he could, but luckily that doesn't matter. But he did just hit him with a, rolled him over, he's got the Saturday Night Ride, the full mount more or less. He's got to let go of the head, pop up and start striking. Liam's got a bump like he's doing, bump. Cover coming out the back door.
Now you got Drake riding a little high.
Drake's up. Good job on that. He's got the submission.
Stay on it, Drake. Get on the top. Go out.
God, this is great.
Wow,
great.
Good scramble, both guys right
nice,
now.
Absolutely. Could be setting up for an arm triangle here. I'm not exactly sure.
I'd have loved to have seen a triangle, but more than anything, Drake's just keeping a hold of this. Keeps his legs up high. Again, waiting for Liam. He's got to try to pummel back in there and make sure he doesn't pop out and give up an arm or an elbow. Get your hands off the mat. Number one, boo-boo.
Come on, let's go.
There you go. Now he's swinging, breaks away, the leg kick. Now he's hitting that soft leg three times on his way out. Good scramble. Good scrap.
Yeah, Drake's moving much slower now on that leg.
Oh,
wow.
That leg looks beat up.
There it is again. Oh, he's got God. Him. Drake, how many more of these kicks can he take? Liam, you got
to
get
him. Start checking those.
There's another shot. Get the leg back. Oh, good job. Let's go, Drake. You got to pick that leg up and get this takedown.
Liam really making it happen here this round.
Yeah, he has to. Good job. Good
nice knee to the solar plexus.
Good throw by Drake.
Wow, at the bell.
Oh,
he did a great job of creating his weakness and then focusing on that weakness and making it a bigger weakness.
Without a doubt.
On it, that was
Drake,
amazing.
He did a good job. He knew that he had to have these takedowns. He knew that there's no way I could keep standing. Look at his leg.
He couldn't take anymore.
That is going to gain some color in about 3 days. I would love to have a look at that leg.
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it looks bad already. I can imagine.
And it's a very effective strategy with someone who does have some inches on you, because if a man can't stand, he can't fight. So when you chip away at those legs, it completely compromises your mobility and able to move around.
But I love the toughness, just the overall fortitude to stay in there.
Yeah,
again,
spread it out.
We try to keep that poker face, right? We can't let him know we get hurt, but at some point he was literally saying, ow, and limping.
Yeah.
And it's like you hate to give away that weakness, but, you know, I mean, it's just a matter of who's going to get after it.
Well, I'm impressed with both of these fighters.
Absolutely.
Big time.
Those legs can only take so much, man, and Liam was just hammering away at those leg kicks as well.
All right, well, we're going to go right to the question.tv, and the poll, the final, is 58% think Drake pulled this one out, and 41% think that Liam pulled this one out.
Interesting. As we await the judge's final decision to see who knows what's what and who's who. Okay. Liam's still ready to go.
That's what I'm saying, man. He's ready. He's ready
that
for
kid,
another two rounds. I love him. Look
he's
at
so
this.
Light on his feet. He dances. He makes it look so easy, and he's, like, aerodynamic.
I just want to yell parkour.
Yeah, parkour.
How fast he hopped up and bounced off.
That was
he
amazing.
Right off that fence.
I was just going to say Anthony
Pettis.
He didn't
get a run at it. He just literally stopped, jumped. He pissed off the thing and fired a kick real quick. He was sick. From
showtime.
A standing position.
He'd be good at boxing, too.
He's definitely
light on his feet.
Incredible footwork.
Parkour training for MMA. I'm in. Yeah. I'm in. I'm sold.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to your judges' scorecard for our decision. Our judges 28-29, 28-29, and 29-27. Declaring your winner by unanimous decision, Liam Morris.
I'm with that.
Yeah, I had to agree. That poor leg.
Hell of an effort from both of them, though, without a doubt.
Oh, yeah.
My favorite fight so far.
They just keep getting better, don't they?
They do.
All right, we're here with
so
your winner with a very, very hard-earned decision, Liam Morris. Liam, hey, you did a great job, it seemed like, early on mixing those strikes up, finding a whole lot of success with those leg kicks. What, if anything, about this fight surprised you?
His wrestling, for sure. It was definitely a college experience. I noticed the difference for sure.
Now you guys had a lot of tight scrambles in there, really mixed thing up. Did you ever feel in trouble? Was there ever a situation like there where you thought you might have been in trouble in some of those scrambles? Some of them looked pretty tight.
The guillotines, he had strong arms for sure. He'll be great. Give him some time, he'll be there just like I will be.
There you go. Well, I know you made a lot of new fans here tonight with that performance. Where can the fans go to find you? Can you tell them any more about you before I let you get back to it?
You will be seeing more of me for sure. This is where I belong. Trust me.
Well, you definitely bring a lot of excitement with you into the cage. I know we're looking forward to seeing more of your career develop. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your winner, Liam Morris. We need you guys to stay in your seat during the bout so that we can keep this thing rolling and keep all the action on track. We appreciate all your help.
Train keeps a rolling, ladies and gentlemen. Kai Brunk coming up against Kevin Burke.
All right, I can dig this song.
Another stamp of approval given.
Love it, yeah, right?
Jen's dancing over here.
I can't help it, I'm loving it.
Jen's gonna be shadowboxing by the end of the night.
It's so much fun sitting here commentating, rap with you two, and I'm having fun, I like it. I haven't been to an event for, it's been a long time.
Feels like home, doesn't it?
Welcome home, brother.
Yeah, man, getting back around the cage. I love my stream. It's been keeping me occupied, you know what I mean? Because I get to watch fights and break things down and do the things that I love, but I keep looking for my pause button and I'm just checking. But I love being back live and just being around it again.
Nothing like it. Just a little slice of normalcy to get back to. Kai Brunk, Real Warrior MMA, fighting out of Des Moines, Iowa. Another one that started fighting because he was bullied.
That's the best thing.
Yeah.
Bruce Lee, that's how Bruce Lee started becoming the monster he is. It's going to be an interesting one. This is a rematch, from my understanding. Mr. Brunk and Mr. Burke have met each other before.
Oh, wait, really?
Yes.
Oh, hey.
Says he was fighting grown men at the age of 18. Started in a backyard fight club after school.
What's the first rule of Fight Club?
Don't talk about but nowadays you tell everybody about Fight Club,
right.
Then you tell them to join, because then you're going to put it on YouTube, so
there you
doesn't
go.
Matter.
Hey, worked out for Kimbo Slice a little
right?
bit.
Right?
Anyway.
Hey, I'm saying, everybody's got that phone. It's all being recorded nowadays.
Yes.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Hit that thumbs up button.
You want to go to cageaggression.tv. Once again, we have your voting on who you think is going to win this bout. It's Kai or Kevin. We're 50-50 right now.
Kevin Burke on his way to the cage out of Summit Training Center, Davenport, Iowa. Said a friend took him to the cage when he was 16, and he has been hooked ever since. He's also very much so anticipating this rematch that he said he's been waiting for a very long time.
Uh-oh.
Well, I'm excited for this. A rematch, a good
Absolutely.
Rematch. Both of them look like they're coming in ready and in shape. Yeah.
Got the game face on. Kevin says his jiu-jitsu and kickboxing are pretty good, and he'd like to think he's pretty well-rounded. So we shall see, ladies and gentlemen. Time will tell.
These fights keep getting better and better, so I just keep getting more and more excited, everyone that comes up.
Well, that's what caged aggression does. Leveling up. Like you said, this is a card for both nights with UFC veterans, LFA veterans, Bellator veterans. No slouches here.
No, definitely not. You know, being a mom, I want to go over and be like, oh, are you okay? But then at the same time, I'm like,
you got to do it.
I know, you just feel that way, you know, it's
Stop,
natural.
Mom, they got there's cameras.
I'll just go check on them after the fight.
There you go.
Behind the scenes.
Bring in some Band-Aids and some antiseptic.
All
Always cool to see a little sportsmanship before the fight as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, our fourth bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Division, powered by the Army National Guard. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 125 pounds. He trains at Real Warrior Academy. Joining us from Des Moines, Iowa, Kai Brook. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'8" tall and weighed in at 126 pounds. He trains at Summit Training Center. Joining us from Davenport, Iowa, Kevin Burr.
Kevin Burr, Kai Brunk, about ready to square off, ladies and gentlemen. Our fourth bout of the evening.
Kevin, you ready? Let's go.
Touch gloves in the center of the ring. Here we go.
Right off the bat, that's exactly Kai throwing that jab, cross, hook, rear leg, the combination.
High energy right out of the gate.
Yes, absolutely.
Utilizing that range, which is great. Look at that kick to the liver right there. Definitely the lead leg. He's already doubled up on the kick. Wow, he decided to do the scissor kick.
A little too early, man. I don't know.
That's might have been a little bit, but
nothing ventured, nothing gained, right?
Oh, got hold of his leg there.
It's a beautiful thing when you catch the leg and then he punches you in the face. You got to let go of the leg, which
absolutely.
Is perfect.
Leave yourself open. Your hands are full. Seen a lot of leg kicks tonight.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive the way that they're going back and forth right there. See, Kevin, he's not throwing as many, but he's throwing a good, solid rear leg and catching the outside of Kai's thigh. You see it start to build up. But again, with Kai, the way that he's throwing, everything's in combinations and in movements. He's switching up his stance. It's definitely like you can see one shot getting through and catching you. So you got to be careful, and it tends to slow the fighter down, i.e. Kevin right now, and he's just trying to be solid and not get caught with anything.
Absolutely.
He took a kick to the face too. You can still struggle with his nose a little bit.
Kai coming with the volume he has. Kevin just definitely has to be on the defensive to watch out there.
Nice lead hook by Kai right there. And the one thing I see, there you go now. See, they're starting to dig to the liver. Kevin's ready to step in and get into a phone booth. It's a fight. The thing is, Kai right now, see again, jab,
nice body shot.
Hook, body shot to the liver. You know what I mean? But he's my man Kevin wants to get this thing into a phone booth. Kai's moving around too much. You got to get this thing in tightened up.
Kai seems to be beating him to the punch, though.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, the way that he's circling around, adding in the feints, throwing his punches two and three, but the biggest thing is punches two and three are landing. There you go.
Ooh, nice
left hook. Here's a combination. Kevin Burke up
there
against
you go.
The cage.
Kevin comes back on. These two are going to war.
Yes.
Oh. Oi. Good job. Good 1-2 down the middle by Kevin.
They're putting the punches together really nice.
Yeah, they are.
Combination.
And the timing of it as well. Their eyes are open. Their chin is down. Their hands are up. Defense. Kai got hit in the eye. You can tell it's starting to swell up. It's driving him nuts.
Just favored it right there.
His left eye.
Oh. His face is... Oh, yeah, that eye is already. It's already shut.
He's favoring that left eye without a doubt. Nice clean techniques from these young gentlemen.
Well, and again, the beautiful thing about watching these two fight is Kevin is just that grinder. Step down, keep his feet down, throw power shots right here. Drops him down, end of the round. Did he get poked in the eye? I'm not sure.
I can't tell. I'd love to see the replay on that if we could.
When that happens, though... Jans, is it? Can you? I mean, obviously you can't see as well. You don't have as good peripheral when one of your eyes is shut. But when you get poked, how long does it take for you to get vision back?
It's mortifying, and it depends how bad the poke is. I mean, I've had, like I said, almost lost my eye one time. I got the whole front of my pupil ripped off, and I kept trying to adjust, and the referee wouldn't even give me time. And that's one of the things is, if it's an eye poke, if the referee catches it, if it's not, it's just a punch to the face, and there's nothing you can do. And I started having depth perception issues. It just depends how bad it is. But you know how when you have something in your eye and it drives you? That's exactly what it feels like.
Fighting in the dark.
On the skin. Yeah, I thought I literally had a stick in my eye. It was driving me nuts.
Well, then no better point of the recent Daniel Cormier-Stipe Miocic fight where Daniel Cormier took, I believe, a poke or a shot to the eye and had a corneal tear, and that just compromised his ability. Like Lee was saying, you can't see those peripherals. So
yeah,
Kai's left eye's closed, and he's not going to be able to see those rights that Kevin's got coming.
It's definitely an issue, an ongoing issue that we've been running, you know, we've been dealing with for a long time. It's just kind of the game.
Here we go, start to round two. Kai coming out strong once again.
Oh, there you go.
Both landed a couple right there.
It would probably benefit Kai not to circle towards the side of his bad eye because that right could come and he might not see it.
Well, now Kevin comes in with the powerhouse takedown, but Kai's doing a good job. These two are just constant motion, and moving.
Yeah, absolutely.
Kai is the one, again, he's kind of light. If he go-goes, I'm going to get up and walk away for a minute, but that was a beautiful job. Kevin's doing a really good job of hunkering down, slowing it down, take away the space, and just melt him into the floor.
Kai's definitely slowing down a little bit. Because of the pressure Kevin's putting on him.
I'm struggling to get out from underneath this one.
You got a half guard there.
Well, and that's the thing. He's in a half guard, and he's got to be careful because, again, the way that Kevin has the underhook on the head and doing a good job of cutting it off, he wants to get that knee out and be able to shoot it in and have full mount. So we're worried about that, and he gets his underhook. Kai gets his underhook finally, but he's got to be careful not to give up this mount, and he does.
He does.
But he's able to get it back. So.
Yeah, 59% in favor of Kai winning this bout.
Nice.
So far.
Good job getting guard back. I'm telling you, he's going to go-go this.
A little rubber guard there.
Getting rubbery right now.
Now, those hits to the very top of your head. I don't feel like those would be the worst ones to get.
You know, the problem, it sucks, though, when they start raining elbows down on top of your dome.
Oh, sure.
It's maddening, right? I mean, it starts to be like, are you serious? It definitely makes you move. You can't just sit there, right? And that's your job on the bottom. Try to switch for an armbar. Good job. Kevin gets up, lands some big shots.
This is shots raining down from Burke. A couple landed big time. Just back in the middle, just swinging.
These two are, they are literally just swinging when they get out in the center. One thing that's going to really play in with Kevin right now is now that Kai is slowing down, Kevin, he's more of the quote-unquote powerhouse, where he just comes through and throws the power punches. It's starting to work because he's going to, look, Kai's taking deep breaths.
Yes.
He's wearing out. This is up to Kevin to try to melt him and just take it over.
Yeah, I was going to say that Kai's quicker, but Kevin's got more power.
Yep.
And Kai's slowing down.
Yep. Because he's been bouncing around so much, he's moving way more.
Well, that and just once you started adding in the wrestling and the one thing that Kevin get in the ground and he just flattened him out, he's literally been the quote-unquote stronger fighter this round.
Looks like he slipped right there.
You know, that's a couple times now he's had to take one to the team.
Oh, he slid out of the triangle choke, pissed off, he's got side control.
Side control, vicious knees.
To the belly hole.
Vicious knees to the rib cage.
Knee on the stomach.
Belly.
There it is. You want to knock the wind out of somebody, drop a knee on the belly.
Oh, without a
doubt. Nice, end of the round.
Man, these guys are going at it. I think Kevin's starting to edge ahead, though.
He's controlling it, I think.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
He's staying busy.
A lot of time on top, eating him up, and that's one thing. Kai is he's starting to look beat up.
Yeah, he's got, and this is his home turf. He's from Davenport, Iowa, this is his hometown.
Got his twin brother over there. Kevin Bird does.
Oh, yeah, there you go. I was going to say, they do look alike.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Kai's taking some beatings to the face. His face is pretty...
big deep breaths over there in Kai Burke's corner.
Red.
Kai Burke's corner. Big deep breaths. I know both are tired, but Kevin seems to be the fresher fighter coming into this third round.
I'm 100%. The thing is, he hasn't had to change his style. And again, when you're Kai and you're moving around, you're bouncing around and jumping around, and as you start to get flat-footed and tired, you're changing up your style. Kevin hasn't changed his style.
Right.
Power shots, blasting through, and just mugging. You know what I mean?
They've only got Kevin at 43% think he's going to pull this one out. I disagree with the viewers on this one.
Well, the tide's definitely turning towards Kevin as Kai slows down. But again, mixed martial arts is one of those any given Saturday or Friday, as it were, kind of sport.
You're just one punch away. There you go, good combination again with Kai leading that lead hook and rear leg, catching the hand, knocking the mouthpiece out on the floor.
COVID. Touch him up, inside leg kick from Burke right in the center of the cage.
Ooh.
Kevin Burke's just
there's the
loaded.
Eye again, there's yeah, the eye again. Blasting.
Kevin seems pretty focused.
Yeah, and he's just walking through it. See, now you see he's catching him after, so Kai closes the distance to throw that 1-2 punch, and then he's getting met with by two or three punches from Kevin.
Oh
right to the liver!
Spinning leg kick to the midsection.
Oh, he spun one off on the liver. Folded him.
Matter of time, ladies and gentlemen.
Fetal position.
It is over, ladies and gentlemen. Kai
left
from
to the liver. Left to the liver.
What did I say? Any
doctor.
Given Saturday. Any given Friday or
they're
Saturday.
Calling the doctor into the ring.
Look at that. Oh,
Kevin
the liver.
Burke.
The liver.
Oh, he's not doing good.
And that's the gift that keeps on giving. You feel that for a long time. Spinning back kick, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, man.
George St. Pierre style, Joe Rogan style.
It'll change the way you look at life, man. The liver shots are no joke.
I thought he had this one, too, and that one spin kick.
Absolutely.
To the, that's all it took.
You're just one punch, on one kick away.
That's it. Can change on a dime.
Oh.
What a great fight, though. Great fight.
He's still on the floor.
Spinning back kick.
Got Kai over there.
Puts away Kevin Burke.
Kai, showing some love.
Kai Brunk showing some concern. Good sportsmanship. Kevin Burke still curled up on the mat.
Y'all think I'm playing, man. This is no joke. He's literally still laying there.
You can get a lacerated liver from that.
Yeah, those the kind of force you can bring, though, you know, bring with those kind of kicks. You spin, you build that momentum and build that force. If you land one of those, man, it's like you said, you can lacerate a liver.
Absolutely, it's scary. Like the mom, like I'm telling you, the mom in the empty comes out. I'm like, oh, I just want to go. I want to go get them a hug.
I want to make them some soup.
I know. Oh, good job.
Kevin Burke back on his feet. Seems to be doing all right. Always love seeing that.
He did a great job.
He really did. Both awesome.
Very
awesome
good,
fight.
Very good.
Fierce competitors. We expect nothing less here at Caged Aggression MMA.
Yeah, you can tell Kai didn't walk away unscathed. He's got some black eyes and he's got a bloody nose.
Yeah.
Oh, he's beat to be damned.
Yeah.
He beat up.
Very rarely do you come out unscathed. Always some measure of battle scar. Awaiting the judge's rendering.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, has called a stop to this contest at 56 seconds into round three, declaring your winner by TKO, Kai Brunk.
Very impressive performance, especially that final spinning back kick from Kai.
I'm excited to see these two come back. No shame.
All right, come on over here and join me, Kai.
Amazing fight.
We're here in the center of the cage with your winner, Kai Brunk. Kai, first of all, let me congratulate you on a very, very hard-earned victory, man. What's on your mind right now, buddy?
The first round was a pretty good filling out process. Me and Kevin have fought each other before, so we kind of know each other's game plan. But that second round started coming in. He was dropping some bombs. I think my nose and my face messed up a little bit, so it was going a little sloppy on my part. My coach had a good read, and I heard him. And I listened to my coach, and that's what got me the W.
Honestly, your face isn't that bad, man. Now, talk to us real quick, man. How does it feel to come out on top in such stunning fashion after possibly being down on the scorecards the majority of the fight?
No, absolutely. My coach told me it was 1-1. I did not believe him at all. I was like, I don't know, man. He's lighting me up. All I had was the center of the cage. But especially being here in Kevin's hometown, I could feel the energy of his crowd. And I want all of his fans to know that Kevin did a great job. My face hurts, so he did his job. Trust me. I just got the dub tonight, that's all.
Well, you guys put on a very, very exciting fight. Kai, I do want to give you the opportunity to include anything that I might have missed. Maybe throw it through shout outs to some people.
I want to start off with saying that my girlfriend Kelsey, me and her have been dating for 3 years, and I haven't been fighting for 3 years. So it's our first time seeing me fight live and the whole time we've dated. So I love that she's here for that. My coach, Nate Williams, I wouldn't be here at all, but I'd be with today without him. thank you for all my friends and family that are here. They're somewhere out there. And then everyone that's watching online. Last of all, thank you to Mike for putting this all together. And then a Real Warrior Fight Team for always being there for me.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your winner, Kai Brunk.
Ladies and gentlemen, because Blake brings the dynamite. I think we're jumping ahead of ourselves. I think Mr. Burke wants to say a little word.
Yeah, everybody.
Sorry about that. All right, I'm joined here by Kevin Burke. Kevin, first of all, I want to thank you for the performance that you put on. You looked like a completely different Kevin Burke tonight, and you know, definitely looked dominant in the opening rounds of that fight, man. Tell us what's on your mind right now, Kevin.
First of all, congrats to Kai Brunk, that was a fight, you know, that was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun. Lisa, can you come here? You guys have seen me grow since I've been an 18 years old kid fighting here, you know, at Cage Aggression. That was my 29th fight. You know, you guys have seen me growing here, you know, get older and, you know, I don't know how many more fights I got. We'll see what comes next, but you know, I've been with Lisa 9 years now. I just turned 27. We've been together 9 years, a long time. And you know, I love you. And we got a family together. Come here. And I went and talked with Lisa's parents, and I was wondering if you would marry me.
Yes!
That's a yes, River Center!
That wasn't the way I wanted to go out tonight. I wanted to go out and do this on a whim, but it is what it is, man. Anything can happen here, and this is my best friend, and it's a long time due. Right?
Kevin, I just heard somebody in the crowd say that is a win. One more time, River Center, for the future, Mr. and Mrs. Burke.
That was awesome.
That was really cool. I was trying to figure out, I'm like, my man is just standing in here. He's like, what's he doing? You know, that's cool, real cool.
Again, back to the action. John James and Blake Goodenbauer about to come in and drop some hammers.
All right. Go to cageaggression.tv. You can put in your poll, your vote, and who you think is going to take this bout. So far, we've got Blake in the lead at 62%.
Blake Goodenbauer is no joke. Without a doubt. We got John James here making his way to the cage from De La Rosa Submission Wrestling out of Rockford, Illinois. Started jiu-jitsu in college.
Okay, he wins 100 on the entrance. I love that song.
They're batting 100. They're batting 1,000 tonight with the music, not 100, obviously.
Got Jen singing over here.
I know, man. I start singing that country, I gotta stop.
You get in the ring, you gotta get in the cage and sing that.
Start
two-stepping. Everybody can start throwing things at me. 100.
I don't think so. You'll have some people standing up. Standing
not
ovation.
When you hear this voice. Not when you hear this voice.
Looking forward to this one, the heavyweights. Like I said, I've called one of Blake's fights in the past and seen some of his other fights. Very, very strong. Very well-rounded as well.
All right. High energy.
Jonathan James making his way into the cage, ladies and gentlemen. Blake Goodenbauer making his way. Fighting out of Nick Tarpin's right here in Davenport, Iowa. Got into MMA to pursue challenges. Looks up to Daniel Cormier. Not a bad one to look up to.
Not a bad one at all.
Blake Goodenbauer, ladies and gentlemen, has very, very heavy hands. Jonathan James needs to be on his defense. Blake Goodenbauer is a large man with very heavy hands.
We got Blake still at 68%. CageAggression.tv, colon. Yeah, these guys, they're getting bigger and bigger every bout. More intimidating.
Yeah, without a doubt. Blake can, Blake's like NyQuil. He will put you to sleep.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds for the Caged Aggression Amateur Heavyweight Championship, powered by Ducky's Formal Wear in Galesburg. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 6 feet, 1 inch tall and weighed in at 242 pounds. He trains at De La Rosa's Submission Wrestling Academy. Joining us from Rockford, Illinois, John James. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6 feet, 3 inches tall and weighed in at 242 pounds. He trains at Tarpon's Martial Arts. Joining us from Davenport, Iowa, Blake Goodenbauer.
Yeah, this is not time for a bathroom break or a snack break, ladies and gentlemen.
Nope.
Touching up in the middle of the ring, Blake Goodenbauer, Jonathan James.
Oh, boy, good shot by Jonathan, throwing the kicks.
Coming out with that low leg kick.
That's it. He fired that right hand and got Blake now good. He's throwing that lead leg kick, or rear leg, I'm sorry, to Blake. And it's breathing down, hits him with the Superman.
Oh, he got him.
Oh, whoa, got told him. You, Blake's on him. Dropping power rights.
Wow, Blake comes in and closes the distance. Now he's got Jonathan's in side control, pushed up against the fence. No bueno right here. Jonathan
absolutely
better get moving.
You don't want Blake having you in that position.
No, especially if he isolates that arm and just unloads on the face. Brock Lesnar, Frank Mir style.
Yeah, Jonathan's in a bad spot right now. Got to figure out how to get his guard back, what he's got to do outside the cage, give up his back.
Blake gets the back. Oh.
There he goes. Sits back. Got the hooks in, going for the rear naked choke.
You better have that defense in strong because Blake is strong.
Got to try to fight that. He's going to switch it over to a short choke, change up the grip a little bit. No.
Got a good position, got those hooks in. He's controlling his body, right?
Yeah, he's got him in a bad position right now with the feet, making sure he's going after a rear naked choke. I can see that Jonathan's trying to turn over inside there and try to get a position, but what he wants to do is he's got to try to get his back flat on the mat and start over. Unfortunately, give up the mount if you have to, but it gets you out of the rear naked, right?
Absolutely.
Now, right now, it's about hand fighting. Make sure if he crosses his feet, cross your feet over the top. But he's doing a good job right now. He's off the fence. He just got to be careful. Again, now Blake, on the other hand, sitting there being patient. You've got nowhere to go.
throw punches. Don't be so crazy about this choke right off the bat, even though he's got it in tight right now.
You can blow your arms out doing that.
Yeah, exactly.
There he goes. Leg move to the mount. Nice.
Oh, taking some headshots.
Jonathan's in trouble, but he's doing a good job of pushing on the leg, getting his guard back. Nice job. Good movement on the bottom. Didn't expect it.
You got an arm bar.
Going for a Kimura.
Is Kimura a fancy word for arm bar?
It's a fancy word for working on the elbow and shoulder, yes.
Okay.
It's a fancy shoulder turn. Good job right there again. Jonathan just that's a lot of weight on him, but he's got to try to turn into him and get the other half of his guard back.
Blake hanging out in half guard there. I think he got it locked in, champ.
He definitely has it locked in, but
gave
it's just
it
his position and where he's at trying to get that lock.
Can't
little
turn
too
him.
Spread out.
John's taking a lot of headshots.
Definitely.
Man. Oh, man. It's hard to watch.
Beating him like a big brother when he grabs your arm and throws it around your face and just starts passing. It's literally big brothering him. Now we're right back to where we started a minute ago, where he's on it. He's got his back. He's laying on the floor, and he's got to be able to try to push off here. Jonathan's in a bad spot. He's definitely, if he can get through this round, we're going to have to make some adjustments.
Oh, yeah. Blake's having trouble getting under that chin to lock in that.
There he is. Good reversal. Turn back. It's over. Oh. End of the round. End of the round. He got the reversal.
Oh, man.
Turned into Blake's guard right as the bell rang.
Right when he did it. Now, the question will be this next round. I like the combinations that Jonathan was throwing. Then he tried to do a Superman, things like that. He just got overwhelmed. When Blake decided to start throwing punches, got him pushed up against the fence. Jonathan's breathing pretty. Make up for that round. That would be about a 10-8.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is going to be one of those where conditioning comes into play. Like all these fights. But yeah, Blake was working really hard to try to get that rear naked in. I wonder how much energy he expended doing that. And obviously, Jonathan on the bottom surviving takes a lot of energy as well.
Jonathan's got a hard head, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is, again, getting your confidence back. He's looking beat, you know what I mean? What do you got to do after a round like that? How do you bounce back?
Right.
I have to say, looking at Jonathan on that stool, he does not look like he wants
to be
here anymore.
He definitely looked beat up,
didn't he? He did not look like he wants to be here.
Yeah.
Blake not breathing too heavy over there. Getting ready to start round two.
Oh.
Starting out with a low leg kick from James.
Hands up.
Big thing, keep those hands up, especially when you're closing the distance. You're going to walk into something nasty if you don't.
Big high kick from Blake.
He needs to protect his face more, John does.
Yes, absolutely.
I want to see Blake throw combinations and set stuff up instead of going for that big haymaker.
Oh! One big power kick, one big power punch. He's trying to close it for a shot.
Ooh.
Oh.
Very compromising position there.
He just
got the tag.
With the Peruvian necktie. My man just Peruvian necktied him.
Wow, Blake, good and bomb.
Basically, he just did a three-quarter Nelson, sat on him, hooked the leg, and got the choke. Impressive.
I have never seen that submission before.
It was kind of a Peruvian. Oh, my goodness.
That looked like some Big Brother stuff right
that
there, too.
That was just a necktie. Wow.
Let out a little scream of frustration there.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Well, that was a cool move. But was that a Peruvian necktie?
Yeah.
There can only be one winner.
Looked like what my big brother would do to me to say uncle.
Yeah, the Japanese neckties, see, they're all neckties. Japanese necktie is a three-quarter Nelson, but it's the way you fall off and you're more on your back. But he kind of, it was a necktie-ish because the way he was sitting back and he just hooked over a leg and still had that three-quarter Nelson. He was still doing it.
So when you do that, do you squeeze your arms together then? You apply pressure?
You hold that position and you keep it this way. Then you lean up with your hips and yeah. So the pressure is your back. It's when you're pressuring into your own choke and it's impressive.
No, thank you.
Yeah, it looks very, very uncomfortable.
I'll stay over here on this side.
See, and I think, again, one of the things is, you know, conditioning plays a huge role in a lot of these fights, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, we got the belt.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, has called a stop to this contest at 41 seconds into round two, declaring your winner by submission due to Peruvian necktie, and new Caged Aggression Amateur Heavyweight Champion, Blake Goodenbauer.
Blake Goodenbauer picking up the W and the strap.
All right, come on over, champ. I'm here with your winner and new Caged Aggression Amateur Heavyweight Champion, Blake Goodenbauer. Blake, first of all, congratulations on the big win. And I want to take you back a little bit. You and I talked some months ago. You had a very, very specific long-term game plan. Part of it included this hardware that you've got right around your waist right now. Talk about the feelings that you're feeling right now, champ.
Well, we're actually moving down to Arkansas. So we didn't know if this was gonna happen, but luckily things were able to come through. Mike, the guy could pull far side of a unicorn pills flying through there. I don't know how he does that to shoot, getting stuff set up, but he does it. So he said we're gonna do it, and I said, all right, let's go.
Now you've always been one that's been comfortable no matter where the fight takes you. Was there anything that actually threw you off of your game plan tonight from your opponent?
I did expect him to go for a shoot in the first round. I caught him with a good cross, and it kind of knocked him back, and I think that's what stopped that. But no, honestly, not really. This last 2 months have just been straight weightlifting, just trying to get my weight up. And for being his age, no offense, but he's still strong as an ox.
Well, and I was going to say, you know, to both of your credit, for two competitors in the heavyweight division, you guys are both very, very light on your feet. I wanted to congratulate you one more time, but before I do let you get back, Blake, was there anything that you wanted to mention before we let you get to the celebration?
To my buddy Harrison Burge, stay safe in Japan, come home to us. My buddy, my brother Nick, again, cough up north, hopefully has a good harvest this year. And to my my brothers, who are both wearing the badge and keeping these neighborhoods safe, please stay safe out there tonight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your winner and new Caged Aggression Amateur Heavyweight Champion, Blake Goodenbauer. Thanks again, Blake. And myself and the rest of the team honestly hope all of you have been enjoying yourselves so far. We're gonna take a quick 10-minute intermission. When we come back, we have all of tonight's professional bouts, including our highly anticipated professional welterweight championship bout. That's all coming up right after this 10-minute intermission.
Nap.
Do nap.
Fighting out of the Sons of Silence, Davenport, Iowa, going up against Evan Stahl out of Marty's Martial Arts Summit Training Center, Spring Lake, Michigan.
Now, if you go to the polls, we've got 64% of our viewers saying that they think that Brandon Knapp is going to take this one home.
By a pretty wide margin.
That is a very wide margin, yes. By over 30%. Now, if you guys have any questions, you can also go to cageaggression.tv and you can ask us questions. You can ask the commentators questions. You can ask Jen's questions. You can ask me questions. You can ask this guy right here, Vin Diesel Jr., some questions.
Yeah, take part in the polls. Take part in the Q&A. Yeah,
ask us
the
some
chat.
Questions. Absolutely. We're here for your pleasure at your disposal.
Absolutely. And without you guys, we wouldn't be here.
All right, gents. Keep it PG.
I'm watching my man walk out.
Oh, is that what you're...
No, he had a big entourage. Crazy.
I saw that.
It's like 300 going down Thermopylae right here.
Right. Leonidas.
Yeah, the gates of hell. It's crazy. Look at him. Oh,
ooh, he's serious. Oh, man. Look at that mean mug.
Yeah, that dude's ready to do some business.
I wouldn't want to get in the cage with him.
I seriously think about it for a minute.
He's on a mission.
Yeah, Evan is ready to get on the good foot and do the very bad thing.
I get a little bit of an adrenaline rush, too. The bigger that these guys get, like it makes my heart rush a little bit.
That's what
if
happens.
They live up to it, which would be the biggest thing.
Oh, yeah.
That's the one thing about, like, you always, the beauty side of heavyweight, you expect that one punch knockout,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
He just took his shirt off with conviction.
Oh, he's mad at you. Okay.
These guys are just mad just to be mad.
I'm a little uncomfortable, I'm not going to lie.
just let you know, it's about to go down.
The bigger the guys, the bigger the injuries, and it makes me nervous.
This. If he goes by the walkout, this is going to be an amazing fight.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
The intensity that they both have right now, but a minute that ding, ding, and that first punch, then we see what happens.
Right? That's Mike Tyson said, right? Everyone has a game plan until they get punched in the face.
Game plan
he
they did. Walloped one time.
He said that, but he said it with a list.
Yeah. A bit of a list. Everyone has a game plan.
Oh, man.
Holy.
Okay, I'm scared.
Look at this.
I'm scared of these
I'm not
guys.
I'm playing with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout
look at
of the
that
evening
mean mug.
Look at the
is
mug.
Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Professional Heavyweight Division. Powered by Reyes Law. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'11" tall and weighed in at 229 pounds. He trains at Marty's Martial Arts and Summit Training Center and is sponsored by the Warrior Dog Foundation, Palmer Chiropractic College, ORA Orthopedics, Covert Canine, Discount Tire, Ape Man Strong, Striker, The Rock Island Brewing Company, La Finca, Qdoba, Little Caesars, and Ruby's. Joining us from Davenport, Iowa, Evan Strong! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6'2" tall and weighed in at 237 pounds. Joining us from Davenport, Iowa, Brandon Knapp!
Brandon B. Knapp about to face off with Evan Strahl. These guys have not taken their eyes off each other. It's about to go down,
oh my
ladies
gosh.
And gentlemen.
This is the most intimidating stare-off I've ever seen.
Yeah, Brandon wins. Intimidating stare, yes. Done. Done.
Oh, God.
Whoa. Brandon opens up with a big left hand, right hand, excuse me.
These are big boys too, you guys don't even understand.
Well, Brandon's switching up with punches and kicks.
He's got to be careful the way he's just kind of going flailing in that way like
yeah,
that.
Very
as
dangerous.
Soon as Evan can step down and really and land those hooks and throw the strong one strong punch, now they're going to slow down a little bit. And now we're going to start putting in the work. That leg kick's already got him changing stances.
Ooh. He got right back
talk
up,
about
though.
That, champ. Coming in with all that emotion, all that frenetic energy, and does that maybe throw the game plan out sometimes?
It's 100%, and that's what you've got to try to avoid, right? Is you want to get out of that tunnel vision as fast as you can, because we got to get you where you're listening and you're thinking. Drill, repetition, repetition, repetition. Feel your autopilot.
He was throwing, they're both been throwing with kind of reckless abandon, so they need to settle down and get back to technique.
You gotta get your balance, right? You gotta get your balance.
The bigger you are, the more you expel that energy, the slower you're gonna become, quicker. These are big fellas, they need to just kind of take their time a little bit.
Oh, the bigger ones too, yeah, more oxygen's required for those big muscles.
That's right.
Well, and that's it, so slow it down, move, and then explode. More of the explosive type punches. Aim it, rock back, and fire, yeah?
Use some strategery, by God.
You're getting tired already.
Well, and there's that almost emotional dump, you know, that adrenaline dump.
That's
come
what you
into.
Want to try to avoid is that street fight mentality, that emotional dump that after 2 minutes, that's why you're not allowed to have that kind of, it can't be a street fight, right?
You got
to
use your smarts.
You can't have that because you use that up and when it wears off, everybody's getting sick.
Oh, yeah. B-Nap has slowed down significantly.
He's got an injury to his right eye.
Yeah, a little mouse under there, he sure does.
See, but I like that Evan has still got a smile on his face, moving around, circling.
Yeah.
He's still bouncing to the same, but he's walking into a jab after jab. So he's got a counter. That leg kick is money.
They're slowing down quite a bit now.
Well, and that's the thing is Evan has definitely, I mean, he's picking up, but he's got to get inside that first punch, that jab, and then he resets. You got to get hit with the jab and keep coming forward.
Right.
And he's not moving his head at all. I mean, a la Mike Tyson, that head movement to get inside.
Exactly. Parry with your right hand. See, throw the right hand after. Jab right hand.
Oh,
there you go.
He landed a good right hook
nice
right there.
Couple rights, absolutely.
Oh,
nice. There's the right kick.
Oh,
left
hand.
He dropped it.
Oh. He's got him.
Evan unloading the box.
Whoa.
Vicious right raining
big shots.
Down. Not
Ref's
left.
Talking to him.
Cancel Christmas, ladies and gentlemen. It is over, and the
first round.
Oh, my God.
Evan Straw making quick work. He had to work for it, though.
He didn't come out unscathed. Look at it. He's got a bloody nose. He's got messed up.
That was impressive,
though. Oh, man.
Though.
They both came out swinging.
Well, I mean, they went 0-60, and then they slowed down real quick. I can only imagine how much of this has to do with the adrenaline dump on behalf of BNAP. I mean, he has the length on him.
Well,
the leg kicks were landing.
Brandon Knapp was doing a great job of just conditioning and sticking with the fight, right? And it's just one of those things that, you know, he didn't have anything left. He spent it all in the first 2 minutes.
Blue squad.
You know, and again, it's like I always tell anybody, there's nothing wrong with cardio. Go out there and get some. The pavement is free. The tennis shoes are, once you get on them, get out. Yeah. But I'm saying everybody needs that because you got to just the anxiety and the nerves of it all is going to zap that gas tank. So you want to make sure it's a big gas tank.
It seems like they had a little personal vendetta against each other the way they came out of that gate, don't you think?
Definitely.
Evan has, he's been in that flex. You know what I mean? That's the one thing I love is that rush afterwards, right? That feeling after you win. The arms get spread
Ladies
out a little
and gentlemen,
bit. Look,
your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 47 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by TKO, Evan Straw.
Impressive victory from Evan Straw.
Come on over here, Evan. All right, we're here with your winner, Evan Straw. Evan, you came in here, put on a great performance against a much taller, much longer Brandon Knapp. What was the game plan coming into tonight, Evan?
Cut the tree down.
Cut the tree down, and you did just that. What are the plans now? I know you got a lot on your mind, so I'm just going to ask you real quick, where's the celebration going down tonight, Evan?
All over town.
All over town, ladies and gentlemen. He's a man of very few words, a ton of action. What else can you add to this, Evan?
Who's next?
That, sir, is a question I can't answer, but I do want to congratulate you one more time. Definitely looking forward to seeing that intensity back in the Canva cage. River Center, let's hear it one more time for your winner, Evan Straw.
Very impressive victory.
Hey, Cage Aggression fans, don't miss out on the official after party Rubies, Beers, Bikes, and Brats, East on 3rd Street. You get the chance to hang out with the top MMA fighters while enjoying the endless draft selection Rubies has to offer. Are you hungry? If so, Rubies Kitchen will be open late, serving you the best brats, burgers, brat burgers, and tacos.
Don't stop.
Facing up Ryan Delph here.
Oh, and this is a fight near and dear to my heart.
Got Childs coming in here from Grace Place out of Ottumwa, Iowa.
Ooh, Ottumwa, huh?
Yeah, Tom Arnold country, yeah. He had friends that got into the sport and decided to follow his friends.
That is Jason Black territory. Man.
Right. Has a little bit of college wrestling experience. Said he's going to be facing off with Ryan Delph, but this is Chris Childs making, Kevin Childs, I apologize, making his way into the cage right now. To my understanding, had a little issue making weight yesterday.
Little issue making 265.
He was over 55 pounds at weigh-in.
Oh, that's a little
bit. Let that marinate for a minute. Let that marinate.
Yeah.
55 and Ryan, pounds overweight.
That's right, because they had to postpone it for so long due to COVID. But Ryan said, absolutely, let him fight me. I don't want to cancel or fight anybody else. So.
Kevin Childs stepping into the cage, getting ready to face off against Ryan Delf.
55 pounds overweight, like, yeah.
55 pounds overweight at weigh-in.
I wouldn't even get on the scale. I just tell him, I'm not making it.
Say, forget about it.
Save your batteries.
I'm already just let it ride, man. Let it ride.
That's right.
Well, he's going up against a very imposing Ryan Delf. Right. To say he's not a massive human being, potential wrecking ball status would be an understatement. This is going to be another one of don't go to the bathroom, don't grab your snack.
No.
Anything can happen.
He
of
wrote
course.
A book, and look, he built that. That's how you do a questionnaire, Ryan. That is how you do a questionnaire. My man got a book. Yeah.
Ryan says he wrestled his whole entire life. Well, the logical next step was MMA.
All right, here he comes. Here comes a boy.
Oh my! Look at the size.
This is a good friend of mine. Oh,
Lord.
Here he comes.
I think he needs to hit the gym.
Yeah, just a little bit. See, Jens, this is Ryan. Let me introduce you.
Please do. Hey, and then yet he's a philosopher the way he writes. I love it.
Absolutely.
Oh, his wife's as cool as he is.
He pulled off some Sun Tzu in this bad boy.
One of these things I always talk about in the stream is I think I just met another unicorn. One of my unicorns.
He
I
is.
Love it.
And he's a patriot. Yeah. He's a patriot to boot.
100%. There
absolutely.
It is. All right, I just met a unicorn.
That's right.
Turned pro in 2008, started out 3-0, and then lost two in a row. Took a couple years off, then came back, lost two more. After another couple years hiatus, and now we are here. This is my second heavyweight fight ever, and I'm ready to get back on the winning side. Ryan Delf stepping in there with a mission, on a mission.
Here we go, guys. This is the fight I've been waiting for all night long. Let's go to the polls. Polls, they say Ryan, this is hands down 80% going for Ryan Delf on this win.
Yeah, very imposing Ryan Delf, but again, this is a sport where anything can happen on any given night. Ryan Delf stepping into the cage, getting ready to do work.
Ladies and gentlemen,
this is gonna be a good fight, guys.
This bout is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Professional Heavyweight Division. Powered by Ritmer Incorporated Excavating. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands an even 6 feet tall and weighed in at 320 pounds. He trains at Grace Place and is sponsored by Lane Williams at Faded Barbershop, Blue Water Bound Photography, and Grace Place. Joining us from Ottumwa, Iowa, Kevin Childs. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands an even 6 feet tall and weighed in at 259 pounds. He trains at Delf's Pro Gym and is sponsored by Delf's Landscaping, Downrange Supplements, the Eckhart Team at Rule and Rule, Host Trucking and Excavating, Keith and Company, Screen Printed Sportswear, Kennedy Chiropractic, Massage Envy, Off Point Pub, Alderog Tire, River Bend Plumbing, Squirrels Tree Care, Traditional Floors, UPA Events, and Wise Guys Pizza and Pub. Joining us from Davenport, Iowa, Ryan L.
Ryan Delf looks like he can give you that double dose of NyQuil, ladies and gentlemen. He might be fluffing that pillow for this young man. We'll see.
He's nothing to mess with, but you know what? In real life, he's such a teddy bear. He is such a sweetheart.
Until you flip that switch,
you can,
man.
That's right. You can never tell just by looking at him, though, could you?
We are underway, ladies and gentlemen, touching up gloves in the middle of the cage. Ryan Delf, Kevin Childs, starting it out, circling each other. Who's going to implement that offensive plan first?
These are big boys, guys. Just the steps are shaking the cage.
Good right leg by Delf right there to soften him up a little bit. There's
slow
another
the big
one.
Man down without
Gotta
a doubt.
Do it.
Interesting to see the difference between the big men. The last ones came out swinging with reckless abandon. These guys are taking their time, very much more methodical.
Way more methodical. Slow and steady wins the race.
Yes. Nice leg kick again.
Breathe it, Ryan. Breathe it.
now, feeling out his opponent, Childs, with his own kick.
You know, the bigger the guys are, the quicker they're going to get a little bit winded, a little bit more tired.
Without a doubt. That's why it's interesting to see them being very conservative with their offense, which is a smart move.
He's doing a good job. Delph hasn't pushed up with the unhooked side, pushing against the cage, throwing those body shots. Just keep him working. And that's all you got to do. Don't waste all your energy. Definitely don't try to pick him up just yet, but just throw shots to soften him up. Right now you can see that he wants, Childs wants to try to turn him and get him against the cage.
Yes.
So a good jockey for position, over-under is always a stalemate kind of area. Good trip.
Nice takedown. Wrestling 101 right there. I love it. Delph in the mount.
The whole table shook.
Now he just needs to slow down, take his time, make sure to just don't get bucked off at this point right here and start to just, if, depending on what you're going after, just sit up and start throwing strikes.
Like I said, he's keeping him staying busy.
Yeah, he's doing a good job now. He's in full mount. They start raining shots down on Childs and start to hurt him a little bit. That's what Ryan needs to do. Just sit up, one punch at a time, don't get bucked off, and just start throwing straight shots to the head and just slow him down. Childs has got to figure out how to get off this fence, and he can only go one position.
Looked like he was slipping for that armbar.
There he goes. There he is.
Massive hit right in front of us, ladies and gentlemen. Just destruction being rained down on Childs.
Man, Ryan is just bringing down the
referee steps in. Saves this young man's life. Canceled Christmas, ladies and gentlemen. Kevin Childs getting pounded out right here in front of us by a powerful Ryan Delph.
Again, it's just one of those situations, you know, when you get beyond your back and you just got to take your time, hold the position, you know what I mean? And then once you get solid, then start throwing one strike and then big, heavy shots and just hold that position. Golden.
So do you guys think that it was equally matched until Ryan got him on the ground?
Well, I mean, it started off with just the feeling out process. Both were trying to be safe, and it happens. You know what I mean? But once he exploded, and then he put the fight away, and that's it, right? Yeah. So it's just, again, they're timely explosions. In the heavyweight game especially, when people get tired fast and things like that, not to mention that when two big molly whoppers out there start throwing punches, they can start going after, you know what I mean? They start throwing these bombs. You can hit that, but it's just landing and capitalizing on that one shot. And that's what he did. When he got that one shot, took him down,
right,
and then start raining shots.
And imagine the force of every single blow.
You could hear him.
Oh,
they shook. Our table shook.
They registered on the Richter scale, ladies and gentlemen.
Absolutely.
But
final particulars from Jason Vargas, our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 31 seconds into round one, declaring you a winner by TKO, Ryan L. Glover.
Very impressive.
All right, we're here with our big winner, Ryan Delph. Ryan, we won't talk about particular situations you keep finding yourself inside this cage, but what we will talk about tonight, how good does it feel picking up that W, man?
Man, it feels great to be back on the winning side. It's been a few years, actually. I took a hiatus, came back, lost a couple in a row, and it feels damn good.
I can imagine. Now, you know, you kept things standing until, you know, the very last second. Walk us through the last couple moments of that fight, especially the finish there.
Man, you know, I felt comfortable standing up there, and he's kind of heavy on that front leg. Those low leg kicks felt good. And then when I got in tight, I could just feel him off balance and took it to the ground. Those, you could tell the hammer fists were hurting him, so just kept throwing those bombs.
Well, I do have to ask you, now that things are back on track, do you have any plans as far as what's next or around the corner?
Shit, let's get it running in October or November or both.
I like where your head's at. Hey, one more thing. Anything you want to add before I let you get to the locker room?
Just thanks to everybody coming out. This has been a long, long event in the making. And thanks to all the sponsors. Thanks to my family and friends who came out, bought a bunch of tables. After party at Off Point Pub. 9/11, always remember that, represent, and thanks to Mike Goodwin for hanging in there and getting this done.
Yeah, thanks to you for the performance. Congratulations on the big win again tonight. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Ryan Dell.
Dominant, dominant performance from Ryan Dell, taking out his opponent in the very first. That was pretty intense, without a doubt. Just always fun to watch the heavyweights fight.
It is my favorite, but it's also very intimidating because I'm a tiny, delicate little flower.
all these fights have been great, including the heavyweight division. But we have another one coming up here. Jordan Henman versus David the Nightmare Glover.
All right, let's go to the polls. Let's see who the watchers think is going to pull this one out. It looks like Jordan is going to take this one so far.
Jordan Henman, no stranger to the cage aggression cage.
All right, he's got a hype man. Look at that. Ooh. He's his own hype man.
I was going to say, that's the fighter. Yeah.
Look at that. I like that. Confidence is key.
Absolutely. How true is that, champ? How much does the mental game play in this sport?
It's huge.
The physical game?
It's everything. They talk about it. Getting into that routine, even your walkout, everything, it starts. People always ask, when does the game plan start? When you go in that locker room, that's when the game plan starts. If you walk out here, that's when your game plan starts. It's not when the fight starts.
Right.
It's every little thing leading up to it to get you motivated to step in there and throw down, right, Darren?
True that. What a great show, man. Big shout out to everybody. Paul Martinez, Justin Holsey, the whole staff and crew.
They've done great.
Oh, their production's always top notch.
What about you, Vin Diesel?
I just do what I can. I'm along for the ride, sweetheart.
You do a great job as well.
Jordan Henman.
Oh, he's got a fuck looking. Got a little following.
All right.
Yeah, and we got some people. So I like it.
Yeah, very, very popular local fighter. Jordan Henman out of Skunk River Grappling Dojo, Burlington, Iowa.
Here's Gabe Lemley. There you see.
That's your boy.
The mask. Now this is my boy Gabe Ken. Good.
But why does his hair look better than mine, though? That's not cool. ask him for a stylist number after the show.
This is fight number three. Okay, so this is their second. I like it. Very cool.
All right.
Oh, this fight just got me. The crowd and the walkout just got me excited for this fight. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, both of them.
What is that like? I've asked Pat about what is it like to walk out to 25, 30,000 screaming freaking people?
Yeah, it's one of those things that it's mind-numbing.
Yeah.
But it's cool, but it's a rush. You know what? It's really weird when you're in the back. And you can hear the other fights, and it lights up in the crowd. You can feel it. You're like, oh my! And you know your turns are coming.
Yeah. Can't even imagine.
Yeah.
That's got to be so hard to stay focused in that atmosphere.
Yeah.
Man.
I mean, but again,
that's part of the training and the discipline.
But that's
though.
How it is. Repetition, repetition. I always talk about feel your autopilot. Repeat, repetition. Because we get this thing where you kind of go numb, but you just figure out you just do things. Like when you get hit hard and you don't know where you're at, your autopilot takes over. Repetition, repetition.
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our co-main event of the evening. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Professional Welterweight Division. Powered by Lakita Hayes and Sweets. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall and weighed in at 171 pounds.
He trains at the CR Boxing Club and is sponsored by Curtis Contracting Corporation and Wiggles Landscaping. Joining us from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, David the Nightmare Clover!
The Nightmare.
And his opponent, fighting at the blue corner. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall and weighed in at 170 pounds. He trains at the Skunk River Grappling Dojo and is sponsored by Frazee Electric, Van Hollen Transportation, Steam Demon Vape Lounge, Bloom Hemp CBD, Vital Proteins, Hinman Home Improvement, Valley Monster Public Tap House, Yabba Dabba's House of Glass, and Squirrel's Tree Care. Joining us from Burlington, Iowa, Jordan the Henchman.
Look forward to this one, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Jordan Hinman versus David the Nightmare Glover.
If you go to the polls, we've got Jordan leading the polls at 78%.
Jordan thinks Glover's a tough guy, well-rounded and game opponent. He just doesn't think he has anything better than him. Very confident, Mr. Jordan Hinman. Kudos to David the Nightmare Glover. He actually has fought Kamaru Usman, our current welterweight champion of the UFC.
That's pretty impressive. You can definitely handle the power then of what you're about to deal with right here from just the look and the way that Jordan is keeping his composure, owning the center, throwing those calf kicks, throwing that right hand.
All right. You can definitely see the skill level in this fight already.
Good knee right there by Jordan. But he's got to be careful because, again, David, when he wants to get that takedown. Oh, he's already got this guillotine on the shot in the knee. Jordan just beating him up right now. Those kicks to the liver.
The Nightmare feels his strength is on the ground, not standing up. We'll see if he's able to take Jordan down to the ground to implement his offense.
Right now, he's doing a good job at least of getting in close and not taking those kicks. Those kicks are going to pay dividends really fast, especially when you're throwing that left one to the liver.
We saw how devastating those liver shots were a little earlier with Mr. Burke.
Yep, I like how he spins off. Heavy on the head, Jordan is when he throws that knee. Really good job. Oh, there it is. Glover's throwing that right hand. It's a mean right hand to get into this takedown and start making this a wrestling match. Get that anaerobic in there and it might slow Jordan down a little bit. Take some sting off of him.
And these guys they're similar heights, similar body types.
For sure.
This is the most, I think, evenly matched fight we've seen so far as that's concerned.
Glover getting him on the ground. Let's see if he can work his ground game. He says it's his strength.
You know, and that's one thing I'd like. While the guard's closed, you got to sit back, sit upright, posture up, and start throwing the punches. Once the legs are open, then you can pass. So you got to watch out for those arm bars. But he did a good job of feeding him by. You don't try to take him back too soon.
Nice uppercut. Wicked right uppercut from Jordan.
Landed that. Ooh, he just dodged a couple kicks.
There you go. Got him with the right hand and stumbled him.
Glover drops him with a short right.
What is this? What is happening here? What is this?
He's just waiting to see if Glover wants to follow on the ground.
There it is. And see, he's got to be careful the way Jordan throwing those punches. He's already starting to get a little winded. And he's, look at the hands are dropping, the chin's coming up while he's throwing. Ooh. And right now, this is where David can catch him with that hook. The patience again.
He's throwing that 1-2, but like you said, he's not recovering and bringing his hands back up.
Nope.
Leaving him open for a counterpunch from Glover.
And I think another thing that Glover's doing really well right now is this wrestling. The wrestling will slow you down. Taking somebody into the deep water and then just wearing them out. Now he's got Jordan's back.
Working a potential rear naked.
This is where he wants to be.
He's got his hooks, got a body triangle in, control the body.
Control.
Can't see if he's under the chin yet, though.
Doesn't matter because he's doing the right thing here. Punches and bunches. Get him to move his arm. Don't go after that choke right off the bat. Throw the punches. Get a 10-8. You've got a long time.
Absolutely.
Right. Stay on top. Ooh, check an elbow to the head right there. A couple of them.
There you go.
Jordan's got to try to figure out how to fight out, get out of that body triangle, flatten your back out. You got to start trying to rise right here, but he's in a bad position because he's got to try to fight everything. The triangle is a hard spot. David's doing a great job. Yeah. Again, don't overdo it. position before submission. I can just carry Miletic in my head over and over. Position before submission. Don't just pass. Score the punches. Score the points.
A little bit like earlier, you were saying the guy, or I forget who it was, needs to turn towards him, get in his guard.
Yeah, well, you got to flatten, you got to get your back flat on the mat. Let them take the mount, but you have to go from there. You're no longer in a rear naked choke position, but you're going to have to work and get out of that mount, but it's better than where you're at right now.
Right. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, I couldn't get out of that.
Double that right hand up. Double, triple.
Jordan doing the best he can to protect himself there.
He's getting slippery.
Without a doubt.
Very slippery.
Flatten him out. Trying to flatten him out anyway.
It's just a big ball of muscle.
See, what I'm looking at right now. Trying to roll, and now again, right here, he's got to get his back flat on the floor, and this would be the only way to get out of it. David's done a good job of falling behind. He's doing a really good job of eating the clock and just and owning the round. Right
what do you call it earlier? Hand fighting? Where they're
lot of hand fights back and forth. Make sure, again, you got to fight the hands so the choke doesn't get in.
See his foot? Got his foot in between his back of his knee right there?
Yeah, that's a leg triangle. It helps him control the body, control position.
Yeah, and if you can get on the other side of it and start to squeeze, it puts a lot of pressure on the abdomen.
I'm going to use that on my toddler.
There we go. End of round one. I would have to say cage dominance for this round was David the Nightmare Glover.
When he finally got there, and again, what it's going to do, I'd be excited to see what happens in the next round. How much energy will Jordan have coming in here and striking? Remember, you never want to fight a Chuck Liddell in the first round when he hits like a hammer. You got to wrestle with him, get a little fatigue, get that lactic acid in there.
Right?
And then you can dive in rounds two and three and when the sting is taken off.
Well, we'll see if Glover has the same endurance to implement his offense like he did that first round. That was a very impressive first round for him.
CageAggression.tv still says that Jordan is 76% favored to win this bout.
Yeah, I'm not counting anybody out yet.
Yeah, I'm not Jordan either. I think this might be an upset. I'm not going to put that out there
any
yet.
Any given Friday.
It's one just, punch away.
That's absolutely right. We've seen it already tonight, twice.
Ask Pat Barry when he fought Chuck Congo.
Oh, Lord, you threw that out there. Yeah, exactly. Never over. Literally never over. We'll see my man Gabe Lindley, what kind of information he passed on, how he broke him up.
Tell you, both fighters have a very strong crowd in support of them. Nice inside leg kick to open up with Jay, with Jordan.
Ooh, landed a nice left hook right there.
Big thing, Jordan's got it. When he's coming in throwing,
nice one too.
He's got to keep that chin down. The chin comes up. And then the hands drop. Ooh.
Nice spinning back kick right there. Second one we've seen tonight. Ooh, nice counter right by Jordan.
Yeah, he did a great job of feigning back off that jab and throwing the 1-2. He just did it again.
He's finding much success
right
with that
hand. There it is.
Take him down.
Ooh, there you go. Good job.
Oh, right back up.
Big knee.
He's got him hurt, got him staggered. Jordan's got to watch out. His hands are low.
Yes, his hands are way too low to be in this exchange. 84% of all knockouts happen when both fighters are in close and someone doesn't keep their hands up.
Hey, we need this takedown now, David, we need a takedown here.
Got his corner screaming for a takedown. He has found more success in his ground game than standing up, that's for sure.
It's definitely where he wants to be.
Somebody's bleeding.
Is he bleeding from his ear?
David's bleeding.
Ooh, all right. Yeah. Not good, but you know what I mean. I'm glad it's not the ear.
Hey, this is a ballet, sweetheart. This is a ballet.
I'm a mom.
Nice kick to the midsection.
There's the punches. Jordan's teeing off.
Jordan's finding killer success with his hands right now.
But David's fading and got him again.
He got
David,
caught.
You kidding me right now? He only takes one, and now they're back on the ground again.
David, you have 3 minutes. Better work now.
3 minutes, the coach is yelling, ride this time out and take advantage because he lost a lot of points there for a minute.
Oh, man.
We can't say it and stress it enough. We've heard it enough tonight. And all it takes is one punch to change the complete dynamic of a fight.
There's a lot of blood.
There is a lot of blood.
A lot of blood.
Hey, you got to pass that guard.
This is a brutal fight, you guys.
David, come on, you got to pass that guard.
Both getting tired.
Yes, absolutely.
If David wants to keep this here, little shots, body, head, little punches before, otherwise getting this stood up.
Yes.
He doesn't want this stood up. He needs to stay down here and take this round. Jordan on the other side. Jordan, you got to break guard. There you go. Come up, go. You got to start getting crazy. Work a triangle. Let's get moving out there and get these points back. There you go. David's running out of steam.
The hands. It's the hands.
They're slipping all over it. They both of them wobbling. Oh, the body shot to the left.
The knee to the left. Cancel Christmas. Shut. It is over.
No, it's a knockout. Took him down with a knee to the face.
Jordan Hinman with a vicious knee to the face, taking out the Nightmare and dropping him. What a close fight. We cannot say it enough, ladies and gentlemen. All it takes is one.
Oh, my God.
What an incredible effort by both fighters.
Holy moly. I can't believe that just happened.
Jordan with the multiple strikes would set up the vicious knee straight to the chin of the Nightmare.
Is he all right? We have a doctor looking at him right now.
We do.
Looks like he's awake. He's back. He's back. He's good. He's good.
How game of a fighter is Jordan Hinman?
Very good. Very good. Very good fight. Great fight. I would love to see him, obviously. My man, Dave Lemley, we were talking about earlier, man. Long time partner, long time friend. We got to get Jordan. What a fight. What a scrap. Conditioning.
I mean, you stand up for that one.
That's pretty, man. That is impressive. Both of you.
Incredible.
Absolutely. Amazing. Amazing fight. Now.
So caged aggression is all about, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, that was amazing.
Nothing short of phenomenal. Jordan Hinman showing what kind of heart he has. What a fight. He just had that never quit attitude. He just didn't stop.
Did neither one of them quit. I mean, that was...
That was a great performance by both of them.
It goes back to what you said earlier. It's one punch, one kick, one knee to the face. That's it. That's all it takes.
And he was setting up those strikes very well coming out of that second round.
And it's finding your groove. And the one thing, though, with David.
That entourage is on fire.
Yeah. You guys deserve it. They deserve it. They did great.
A gritty performance by both of these competitors.
Neither one is walking up. Look at these guys. They're both beat up. Wow. A lot of testosterone in that fire right there.
That's some good gal fighters, too.
No, ladies and gentlemen, this one in particular.
Referee, Bruce Allen has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 44 seconds into round two, declaring your winner by knockout, Jordan the Henchman Hinman.
He definitely worked for that one.
Yeah, he did. Yes, he did.
Come on over here, welcome away, Jordan. All right, we're here with your winner, Jordan Hinman. Jordan, first of all, congratulations on a very, very tough and hard-earned win, man. What's on your mind right now after that win?
I got a headache.
Got a headache. Well, look, you've spent some time here over the last year or so bouncing back and forth between weight classes. What are the plans moving forward as far as that goes?
Get rid of this headache.
Get rid of the headache. Well, look, I got an easy one for you. Someone over there on the side was wanting to know if you were okay. You have a headache, but look, anyone you want to mention before I let you get to the celebration?
The best woman in this world. She's pregnant. We're going to have another baby in March, so...
Aww.
I'm going to focus on whatever she needs.
Now, hang on. I want to give you a quick look at something here. I want to bring your attention to the screen. We got the finish up, getting ready to get up on the screen right now. Why don't you walk us through the last couple moments there, Jordan?
We were beating the shit out of each other, and he fell first.
Plain and simple. Jordan, I always appreciate the time we get to spend together in the cage. Always appreciate your performances. I want to congratulate you one more time. Let's make some noise, ladies and gentlemen. Your big winner, Jordan the Henchman Hinman.
Just takes one. What a knee, though. What a knee.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jeffrey Wilson of Everything Combat. And this is former UFC welterweight champion and UFC Hall of Famer, Pat Miletich.
And I'm Jens Pulver, former UFC lightweight champion.
Get ready for a very special Caged Aggression two-night event, September the 11th and the 12th.
We'll be broadcasting live from the River Center in the hotbed of MMA, Davenport, Iowa.
Jeffrey and I will be calling the fights on Friday, September 11th.
And I'll be commentating the fights with Jeff on Saturday, September the 12th.
You can join us via live pay-per-view for the largest event in Caged Aggression history.
We will be featuring veterans from the UFC, LFA, Bellator, and more as they take to the cage in front of our live audience, as well as our worldwide pay-per-view audience.
Like many of you, the venues, promoters, and fighters have had a rough go of it in 2020. But we're all fighters by nature, and we're not going to take this one lying down. Show your support for the sport of MMA by going to cagedaggression.tv and buy your subscription to this event, which will be highlighting many of the best fighters in the Midwest.
It's going to be an event you won't want to miss.
Event of the evening.
You ready for this? You guys ready?
Definitely ready.
Jens, you ready?
I'm excited. After that fight right there,
I know. It feels like that should have been the finale.
Right. It seems like it at this point, doesn't it?
That was a beautiful co-main, and I expect nothing less from our co-main event, Eric Wisely versus Frank Schumann, ladies and gentlemen. Said to be Eric's final fight, his retirement fight.
This is his final fight.
Not the Conor McGregor retire and come back 12 times. This is it.
Hey, don't talk about Conor that way, all right?
I love Conor, but I'm just saying, this gentleman's final time stepping into the cage.
Wow, that's a big deal.
It is, without a doubt.
And we're doing the poll right here on cageaggression.tv, but it's not pulling up yet, so I can't see what people are saying. Let's try again here.
Says he's hard to hit. Cardio's always on point. Does not forget that he loves to kick. Should be a very, very interesting fight, ladies and gentlemen. This gentleman has fought in Strikeforce, UFC, Bellator.
Strikeforce, though. It's great to hear that name, Strikeforce.
I know,
Bellator,
right?
Bellator, UFC. Like I said, he's done a phenomenal job representing Iowa.
Can we real quick, before this fight starts, talk about the poll we took on the best-looking commentator?
Oh, yes, yeah, I know I won that. I know I won that hands down.
You smashed it. I got a face for radio.
I won. Like,
I know I got a face
for
radio.
Is it sad they
haven't even... But Jens got second. Vin Diesel Jr. got third.
I know.
Oh, Diesel Jr. got third. I got second
on
the poll.
It's even sadder that our beautiful co-host here this evening hasn't even been shown on the camera, and she won.
Yeah, didn't even know what I didn't know what I looked like. I feel like that was a sexist vote, though.
That's all right, though. I'll be more than happy to take third to this beautiful young lady sitting here. And this beautiful young man sitting next to me. Little Evil.
Beautiful legend to the left.
Without a doubt. They're just killing it on the music tonight, right?
All
right,
now this is my favorite
song. Oh. I don't know if I...
This makes me think of Michelle Pfeiffer, though.
Frank Schumann making his way to the ring.
Oh, yeah!
Out of Resurgence MMA and Wanderlei Jiu-Jitsu. I'm assuming that's Wanderlei. Age 5, his father put him into karate and he never stopped. We shall see how it plays out for this gentleman. He faces off against the very accomplished Eric Wisely in his final fight in his mixed martial arts career.
Final fight, huh? I'm glad to be sitting here calling this over to you.
I'm just waiting for Khalil to come out with a mic. I mean, it sounds like it's a live show right now.
Khalil's still alive?
Yes, he's still alive. And his hair is, he's still got the six braids on top.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry. Edit that out.
I mean, I hope he's still alive. Now you got to worry.
Looking forward to this main event of the evening, capping off night one of Caged Aggression, Return of the Champions. This has been epic, ladies and gentlemen. And again, we have a whole nother night of fights tomorrow night, where I will be calling the scraps with UFC Hall of Famer Pat Miletich, as well as our lovely co-host here, Leah.
That's me. I'll be here.
Absolutely. Smurfly.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event of the evening, scheduled for five-minute rounds for the Caged Aggressions Professional Welterweight Championship, powered by Yabba Dabba's House of Glass. Introducing first, fighting at the red corner. He stands at even 6 feet tall and weighed in at 171 pounds. He trains at Resurgence MMA and Vandalay BJJ and is sponsored by Black Sheep Inc., Dick's Doggy Daycare, .com Vinyl, and Chris Johnson. Joining us from
ladies and gentlemen,
Frank the Nightmare Schumer. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5 feet 8 inches tall and weighed in at 169 pounds. He trains at Summit Training Center and Iowa Top Team and is sponsored by Aegis Credit Union, Squirrel's Tree Care, Mike's Transmission and Auto Repair, Designer Concrete, Markham's Saloon and Restaurant, J. Farr Construction, Foley Tree Care, London's Auto Spa and Express, and Gary's Tattoos. Joining us from Clinton, Iowa, he's your reigning Caged Aggression Professional Lightweight Champion, Eric Little Lee Wisely!
All right, gentlemen, you're fighting for the Professional Caged Aggression Welterweight Championship. We went over the rules in the back. Fight clean, fight fair, fight hard. Red, do you have any questions? Blue, do you have any questions? Touch them up now if you wish. Let's do this.
All right, here we go.
We're gonna see how Frank Schumer does. Schumann does. He is a replacement for Eric Wisely's original opponent. Let's see how well he does stepping in kind of at the last moment-ish.
Yeah, his demeanor, I like his calm. He's just, you know what I mean? Maybe he might be too calm, that's the problem.
Definitely a trained professional. Cool as a cucumber, heading out, squaring off in the middle of the ring right here for our main event, Frank Schumann, Eric Wisely.
That initial feeling out process, standing in the center. Nobody wants to commit to anything too much, too soon, too fast.
Absolutely.
Boy, good counter.
Missed that kick, and
Schumann
Eric made him pay for it.
Three shots, and then back over his head and through the knee.
Controlling the center of the cage here.
Hands up, Frank.
Switching his hands up.
Making it harder to anticipate the offense, I would imagine. Switching stance.
Well, and that's it. I mean, this feeling out process, which is good. They're both trying to throw feints. Look at everybody trying to set something up right now. Nobody's really fighting for anything. Good calf kick by Wisely. Another right hand right there as he moved off. See, I need, why is he getting up and moving? That's what I need him to do. He needs to start moving around and see what he does, right? Schumann feels like he's a little more, he's a little stiff trying to counter something. There's the kick right to his head, caught him. He slipped, all right. All right, so never mind. I thought it was a kick to the head, but it was a slip on the paint.
Ran right into that.
This makes me, they're just one punch away. Someone's one punch away from doing something. It's weird where they're both aiming. They're being calculated. They're being calm. There it is, that calf kick just got him again. Oh, it ruined it. That's it. That calf kick is already switched. That calf kick is no joke. That's it.
You think that's it? That's all it takes right there?
No, those calf kicks. Now he's hurt, switched up his stance. Now it means his power hand is on the other, is in the front now, and he's got to use this. Now Wise is going to go after the other one. Calculating.
Wow, that is calculating.
those calf kicks, you got it, like, again, especially the way that Schumann was doing it. I mean, it is one way to check it, plant down and plant, you know, for the thigh, without a doubt. But it's, again, leaves that calf open and get kicked, and it's crushing.
Oh, we got him again.
Fighting at home with that little shit kick.
Well, and that's it. Now he's doing the other leg. What happens when both of them get done? Catch him with the uppercuts. See, like I said, when Wisely moves around and breaks out of things and gets out of these clinches, then he's golden. Setting it up, you know, picking his punches, picking his shots, landing those kicks is great. Schumann, this is what he needs to do, especially the leg injury. He's got to sit in here and keep this thing. He's got to take away the movement and get him in the quicksand.
Right. What is he holding behind his leg there? What is he doing there, Jens?
Just a spiral ride, just kind of inside on that leg and then putting the pressure and just kind of keeping him, keeping the legs apart, something to hold on to.
Okay.
Oh, there it is again.
Thunderous leg kick.
On the other side, then he comes in with that lead right. Beautiful. He's going to have to start checking these.
Inside leg kick. Definitely finding a home with that bad boy.
My favorite is the focus in their eyes. You look at their eyes, they're just so focused on each other.
Absolutely.
So fun to watch.
There's that right hand, lead right coming in.
Hands up, right.
There you go. Jab, lead, hook, right. Left hand, sorry.
Hands up. Hands up, Frank. Good block, Frank. Good block. Frank, hands up. He will never run out of energy.
Hit
the whole time and
win on Frank. Stay long.
Yeah, we do.
I love it. There
he
is.
Inside leg kick.
He's down. He's down.
There's the kick. He's putting him away. Brown down. Oh, all right, he's going to try and get the guard. Wisely gets away, stands him up.
See if he can stand on that.
Then even do it.
Is he all right? Oh.
He's in a lot of trouble.
You can tell he's in pain.
There's that lead hook.
So much pain.
There's the kick.
Oh, got him. Referee might have to step in here. He can't stand on that leg.
Stand him up.
He's not going to be able to continue.
He's got
to
get up. He's got to get up. He can't.
Wow, what heart.
He can do.
Yeah, that guy's got heart.
I'm telling you, these calf kicks, man, amazing.
Look at him.
And he's just nice, composed. He's not setting anything up. He's just getting him back. I mean, it's perfect.
Oh.
Trying to take it to the ground.
He's
I don't think it's going to happen.
Nothing else he can do.
Frank's got heart, though. He got back up how many times now?
Yeah, right? And then he got the round. Now he's got to try to limp off. This is going to be bad.
Oh.
Trying to fight it off. That adrenaline's going.
Look at that. It's already purple. This calf is purple.
Yeah, on both sides.
It's bad.
She was showing it. Crazy heart.
Wow.
I mean, imagine the pain that goes through your mind when you're kicking it and you can't even stand up anymore. It's like you can tell he doesn't want to quit. He doesn't want to take the punch. It's like, and the referee, at some point, you're going to have to stop this. But, I mean, that's just a vicious, vicious kick, that calf like that on the underneath the knee right there. It's impressive.
Yeah, and it's a strength that a lot of us don't possess at all.
Yeah,
without a doubt. But again, a man can't stand, he can't fight.
Exactly, right?
Yes.
Dang calf kicks. I love him, but I hate him. Oh, I hate him.
You look at Eric right now. Look at him. He's slapping his guys. He's kind of singing the song.
He's enjoying it because he knows what he needs to do, and it's just a matter of setting it up, right? Of course, Schumann's going to do whatever he can to try to not get kicked there, but it's just a matter of time.
Right, right.
We know you're wounded on both sides, yep. So what are you going to do? What are you going to do to change me from kicking your legs?
Yep.
He seems to be moving around on her pretty good, but I'm sure another
one kick will change
one
that.
Kick. Yeah. We're about to see that.
And he can't even bounce on him.
Oh.
If it ain't broke, don't break it. He's going to go for that leg.
Well, and I like it again because now Wisely is doing what he does. Get up on his wheel, move around.
Good job, Frank.
Nice right. Just starting
to train. He's running away from him.
Wow.
Eric running away from Frank.
Poke to the
poke
eye.
Poke in the eye, poke in the eye.
Obviously, that leg is it's killing him, but he's still moving around on it, chasing Eric around.
It's the fight business.
Let's go, E.
Referee taking a look at that eye. You just see that so much in fights. I mean, it's been going on for a long time, but eye pokes,
there's, I mean, it's, again, we were talking about it all the time, we break it down all the time, but when people, that's how they, like, when you're just playing around in your hand, you have your hands open when you're feeling things out.
Yes.
And then it's a flinch, boop,
yep.
boop, and if they're coming forward, boom, you know what I mean? It yeah. just happens. So what do? Put a glove, even the pride gloves that were longer than the head, you know, they, you can still get poked at. It yeah. just happens because people want to, they don't want to walk around with their fist clenched right. the entire time, so they're playing this game, and if yes. they get caught off guard, their hands pop out.
You see John Jones do that quite a bit.
Oh, they all do it. That wrestlers especially feel and grab, right?
With their hands open, yeah.
I love how they keep shaking hands before they come back together to fight.
Class act, absolutely.
Respect.
There's
oh, yeah. There it is.
There it is.
There it is.
Took that leg out.
Dropped him with that yeah. right leg kick.
You called it, Jens.
There you go, and he keeps getting up, hoping it'll switch him up, but it's one of those things. Good shot. Why is he throwing the shots, moving out of the way? I like when he moves. Deep kick to the chest. I like when he moves around. It's what he does.
I tell you what, there's absolutely no punk in Frank Schumann. He is.
No, oh, there's no quit, man. My hat goes off to him. The heart, the courage, his heart is unreal.
He keeps
getting up. Ref, you got to do it. You got to do it, ref. Man, it's up to the ref, man. You got to go right now. This is a bad situation.
He can't.
He's
got
to stop him. My man tried.
The referee called a stop.
My man tried, but that's what you got to do.
Frank Schumann in real pain right now.
Unreal. I need the doctor.
He's screaming, though. He's in pain.
Yeah, he is without a doubt in pain.
He's in a lot of pain.
Do you think it's broken?
Well, what it is, it's the damage to the sides of it. It's like a Charlie horse of magnitude. And whatever that... The pineal, whatever that pineal's gland or
pineal.
Whatever, it's that, when that thing gets hurt, you've seen it happen to Sugar Shane, when he was in there and he was trying to step down, his foot was going limp. When that nerve gets damaged, there's nothing you can do.
The perennial nerve, I believe it's called, yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
perennial.
Did I say pineal? The perennial.
He can't stand right now. He can't even stand being held up.
He's definitely going to need some help getting back to the locker room. What a great fight and a great effort. Incredible
wow.
final fight from the very talented in game, Eric Wisely.
Now, how much recovery time does that leg take?
I don't even want to know. That could be, literally. You're not even going to see a bruise on that for about a week. I mean, those are beyond deep. You ever get like a deep bone bruise or a deep muscle
oh, yeah.
bruise?
It takes a long time.
That's times 20, because now you're wrecking the ligaments and everything. Not to mention, you know how wound deep that calf is? Mm-hmm. That muscle is extremely, it's very big, but it's wound so tight in there, right? Like with your forearm. That, you got to be careful. I've seen people get kicked so hard in the leg, they literally had to open up and let the calf or the muscle lay out on the table until the swelling could come back and put it back in. You know
wow.
what I mean?
I'm ready to eat. I don't know about you.
What a chop down.
Yeah, that was an incredible effort by him. Very impressive performance. That's how you want to go out, right?
Without it. I mean, what a way to ride it out. Now the question will be, everybody faces that mortality, and do they stay retired? Do they come back?
Right.
You
performed so dominantly, you're like, you know what? I think I got one more.
Well, not only that, as we start to get into
he's
that
he's being
out.
Carried off out of the cage right now.
Without a doubt. I mean, he's walking on a little bit, but I mean, those were
oh,
some...
Oh, poor dude.
Those are just wickedly powerful.
He had heart, though, didn't he?
He never quit. That was
he never quit. He got up every
many.
Time.
And I can't even begin to describe what that... Well, you would know it. That feeling of
ladies
helplessness.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee,
you
Bruce Allen,
he did
has
amazing.
Called us out to this contest at 1 minute, 19 seconds into round two, declaring your winner by TKO and new Cage Aggression Professional Welterweight Champion.
There it is.
That's how you want to go out right there, folks. Getting thanks from the El Jefe.
You think if I gave him $5, he'd let me wear it?
Champ.
For like
champ.
A minute? If I gave him $5, would he let me wear it?
Eric, congratulations on the big win, man. And you know,
I wouldn't do that
you've
to
done
him.
Something that no one else in Caged Aggression history has ever done. You are the first person to hold two professional championship titles at once. I got to ask, what's next after such a storied career like that, my friend?
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank Frank for taking the fight on 10 days' notice. Obviously, my guy, something came up, and that's what it is. But yeah, thanks to Frank and his camp for taking it on a short notice. But as for the future, I'm retiring after this. Although that is a hard thing to do after winning two divisions, I'd love to defend them both. It's just time, and I got a baby coming on the way, a 16-year-old boy that keeps me busy, and a beautiful wife, Destiny Wisely. Yeah, new house, new job, new everything. Yeah, it's gonna be hard to quit on that, but I'll be in the gym keeping people going, and then, you know, getting the next line coming in and keeping them in good shape and elusive and tricky.
Well, we all know your favorite part of the fight game is getting ready for the fight. We know there's no way that you can stay out of the gym. And honestly, watching your career over the years, we know that with your drive and dedication, the sky's the limit with you, Eric. So again, I want to congratulate you. And before you step out of this cage, for the last time as a competitor, is there anything at all that you want to add?
I'd like to obviously thank all my family, friends, my wife, my son, you know, everybody who kind of carried me and helped me out. These guys have been here around for a long, long, long time. They've helped me tremendously. And obviously all my sponsors, they make the training and the life, you know, style a lot easier. Definitely all the fans, that's what I'm going to miss. For me, fighting wasn't necessarily what I loved to do. It was the training, the high level of training. But the only reason I come out here is to put on a show for you guys. So it's going to be a hard one to step away. Unless, I said, somebody kept asking me, unless something big came up. And I would say if it came up soon and not, you know, a year down the road, I would probably take it up. But other than that, I just got to move on to a family and a career. And I want to thank Carl Foley and his family, because finally he got me to come over and work for him, and now I'm in the same line of business he is. So thank you guys and everybody else that comes here every night.
Well, on behalf of the rest of the family, did I cut you off?
No. I was going to say, obviously, I love this show the most around, you know, this area. And for me personally, the biggest show out there. I love to finish in here for Mike and everybody else. So thank you, Mike, for letting me have my retirement fight in your cage. So.
Well, I wanted to say thanks again for such a great career, all the awesome performances that you've put on. I know I speak on behalf of the rest of the Cage Aggression family when I say, you know, we will miss seeing you compete here in the cage, but it's on tape. That door has been left open, so we will all remember that. I'm looking forward to the next time we get to talk, Eric. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the history maker, your first professional dual weight class Cage Aggression champion, Little Lee Wisely. I wanted to remind everybody one more time, we will be right back here tomorrow night, same time, same place, for our second portion of our two-night event. Don't forget, we will have our always popular all-female bout. That's coming up right back here at the River Center tomorrow night. Thank you, everyone, for being here.
Hey, Cage Aggression fans, don't miss out on the official after party at Ruby's Beers, Bikes, and Brats, east on 3rd Street. You get the chance to hang out with the top MMA fighters while enjoying the endless draft selection Ruby's has to offer. Are you hungry? If so, Ruby's Kitchen will be open late, serving you the best brats, burgers, brat burgers, and tacos. Hey, Cage Aggression fans, don't miss out on the official after party.
Just wow, ladies and gentlemen. Caged Aggression, they came, they saw, they conquered. I don't know how many different terms I have to cover what we saw tonight. Grit, endurance, heart, personified. Some absolutely amazing fights, some amazing submissions, some amazing knockouts, some incredible performances. We're not sure if we've seen the last performance of our friend here or not. Wow. It was amazing. We had our great friend Liam Mathis here helping us out at cagedaggression.tv, helping out with the chats, the Q&A, all of the polls. This is only night one, ladies and gentlemen. We still have night two coming tomorrow with myself, calling the fights with UFC Hall of Famer Pat Millich and our lovely friend here, Liam Mathis. UFC, former UFC lightweight champion, legend of the sport, Jens Pulver. Break it down for us, man. What did we see tonight?
You know, we got to see fights. We got to come out here and we got to watch live fights. And it's just great to see these kids come out here and put it on and throw the way that they throw. There was a lot of great fights tonight, but Wisely putting a stamp on it at the end, the calf kicks. I still feel the pain. You know what I mean? It was amazing for him to close the distance, to close his career like that. And if he does come back, even better. But, you know, he's got two belts and everything like that. It was just a lot of fun to watch. It was great to hear a crowd. It was a blast. I appreciate it. I had a lot of fun, man.
You were
Thank
in your element. You were in your
I
element.
Was,
you had
man,
a smile on your
this.
Face the whole night. It was amazing.
I had a great time.
We want to give a shout out to our viewers, too, who participated in the polls and the Q&As online. And don't forget that we will be here again tomorrow so that you can be a part of that as well. We enjoy all of you.
Absolutely. We can't thank you enough, ladies and gentlemen. Again, this is just night one. We have only just begun. Part two will be even equally more jam-packed, more action-packed, more entertaining. Like I said, these fighters brought their A game tonight, and I expect nothing different tomorrow night. Ladies and gentlemen, for myself, from the featherweight champion, I'm sorry, lightweight champion, Little Evil, to our good friend, Liam Mathis, ladies and gentlemen. Again, tune in tomorrow, cagedaggression.tv. We have only just begun. Peace and so much love, you guys. Have a great night.
Sorry. We'll see you tomorrow.